naman on the other hand of the stick has won their last two. Of course, spearheaded and basically inspired by the return of Asi Taulava. Not necessarily his production per se, kasi 14 points a game pa lang naman ang nababanat niya. But yung mere presence of Asi has helped a lot.
Correct. Especially guys like Harvey Carey and Jimmy Alapag na talagang nakita natin. Nag-ibang tema ng laro nung bumalik itong si Asi Taulava. Dahil alam naman natin, may inside information na tayo na very close itong mga Philams na to.
Aba, parang family na pala sila.
Oo. Well,
speaking of family, the starting fives for both teams for Talk and Text. As you see, Harvey Carey breaking the ice here. He's joined by Asi Taulava, Norman Gonzalez, Jimmy Alapag, and Bong Ravena. At para naman sa Barangay Ginebra Chin Kings, you've got Bal David, Mark Caguioa with black hair today, Eric Menk, Alex Crisano, and Jun Limpot. Ang kaiba lang dyan si Alex Crisano kasi nga, si Rommel Adducul po, mga kaibigan, ngayong araw ay nag-graduate po. Ewan ko lang, hahabol daw siya ang sabi, pero we don't know if he will actually make it for the game, but he will try his best. Pero congratulations once again to Rommel Adducul for earning his degree. There's a miss there by Alapag, and the loose ball is picked up by Jun Limpot. Score po natin 2-0, 10:50 to go here in the first quarter.
A surprise starter here for Barangay Ginebra, Alex Crisano, filling in the slot. Na iniwan itong si Jun Limpot. Ano ni Rommel Adducul.
Tingin mo ba sinong mas makakabuena sa oras kaya? Si Crisano or si Calpito?
Malagay ko si Alex plus dalawang wingman sa isang point guard. So definitely mamaya makikita na natin na isang wingman dyan. Either si Sunday Salvacion or itong si Lago.
That's right. Well, back to live action, folks. Phone fouls looking to add on to this very slim two-point lead. Harvey Carey banging inside. Out to Taulava. 16-foot jumper off to the left. Battle for the rebound amongst the boys with the headbands. It goes to Menk, but couldn't get the bid that cleanly. Medyo natapik ni Bong Ravena, and they get the ball back.
Makita na tayo ng mga magagandang execution.
Kakalas na yan ang kanilang regular game. At coach, itong Barangay Ginebra naman, their last three losses have basically been painful losses sa end game.
Correct.
Eh, sa tingin mo ba, it's a matter of composure and maybe leadership sa end game? Kasi sino ba ang pwede talaga maging leader dyan? Merong Bal David, merong Jun Limpot. Pero malamang definitely kailangan veterano, di ba?
Well, if you talk about leaders during the end game, definitely the leader would be the head coach.
Correct.
Coach Alan Kaibig.
Pero yung nasa court.
Oh, inside the court, it would be the extension of the head coach. I would prefer it would be the point guard, no? But at times, players with the caliber of Eric Menk, Mark Caguioa, Jun Limpot, sometimes partner, yung individual tendencies nila during the end game, mas namamayagpag compared to the team tendencies which they should execute very well during end game.
Well, a ball game is 48 minutes and you can't just play a good 44 minutes and then collapse in the last four. But so far, the Jin Kings have been trying their best to check that as they are trying their best to get back in winning form after losing their last three. This is Harvey Carey. To Ravena to Asi, out from three. Faking, kicking out to Bong Ravena. Has all day to shoot. In and out, and Alapag says, where'd the ball go? Here it is, it's with Eric Menk. 4-on-2 break, Limpot doesn't seem to see Bal David, but he goes to Menk, dancing in the paint. Can't get the finger roll to drop against Norman Gonzalez. Pero meron tayong foul.
Jun Limpot opting to pass to Eric Menk instead of the wide open Bal David down low.
Hindi nakita, no?
Hindi niya nakita, pero Eric Menk on the way to the basket on a screen move was fouled. He'll now have two free throws. Break this deadlock at 2-all.
So medyo not the picture-perfect fast break you'd want to see the Jin Kings running with three big men in one point guard. At yung bola pa naman ay nasa isang center.
Oh, the anchor of it was Jun Limpot, not a natural point guard. Hindi siya sanay na siyang nagtitimon during that fast break situation. Usually talaga point guards ang bibigyan mo ng bola. Ball in the middle, fill the wings. And at that time, Jun Limpot, hindi niya talagang forte yun.
Well, anyways, nakabawi naman tong si Major Payne para kay Jun Limpot as he booked his first two free throws. 4-2 na po ang ating score with a two-point lead in favor of the Jin Kings. We have a quick foul here with the battle of positioning inside. Bong Ravena gets a foul from Mark Caguioa. Ito interesting to coach. Napapanood ko na yung mga games ng Talking Tech this year. They really like posting up Bong Ravena.
Because Bong Ravena, for his spot, the two spot, matangkad si Bong Ravena, no? Clearly, magkakaroon ng maraming mismatches. At this one takes into play Bong Ravena against Mark Caguioa.
Alapag 4-3. Wala. And Mark Caguioa scatters for the loose ball. Pero yun nga, sinabi mo, merong ang height advantage ng si Ravena kay Caguioa. Siguro mga 2 inches, no? At maliban pa dun yung experience factor.
Yun ang pinaka-importante ito, no?
Jun Limpot, showing some experience against Asi, getting him off his feet. And we got a stoppage in play again as we see a foul against Alex Crisano. And we'd like to remind you folks that Timex is the official timer of the 2003 PBA games. Inbounding from the sidelines is Eric Meck. This is Bal David against the bat. Parang 2-3 zone itong top and text.
Correct, TJ. It's a 2-3 zone defense being applied.
And Eric Meck says, I will try again. And he does, getting his first field goal.
Not giving up, Eric Meck, despite being blocked by Harvey Carey, this time doing the lefty and scoring underneath.
Asi Taulava trying to get the baseline. Door is closed shut by Crisano. Alapag down the middle, over everybody, won't go. Offensive rebound for Norman Gonzalez, something he does quite well for his height. And he picks up a foul to boot, and he will troop to the foul line, I think. Yes, he will.
Good positioning on the part of Norman Gonzalez, getting that offensive rebound and going hard for the basket. Eventually, he was fouled, he missed the shot, but will now take two free throws.
Alam mo, Coach Leo, itong si Norman Gonzalez reminds me of yung mold of a player like mala Chris Jackson, yung mga magagaling rumiban kahit maliliit at hindi ganun kalakas tumalon.
Oh, diba? Freddy Abuda type.
Yun, sa payon, Freddy Abuda.
Role parang, players.
Parang may magnet sila sa bola eh. Parang basta na lang dumadapo yung bola sa kanila wherever they are.
Oh, sabi nga nila, it's not your height in getting those rebounds. Diba? It's your heart.
It's
in
your
wanting,
heart.
In wanting to get those rebounds.
That's right. Norman Gonzalez attempts his second free throw. It won't go. Alex Crisano high up over everybody for the rebound. 6-3 ang score after that split of Norman Gonzalez. 8:07 to go in the first quarter.
So Alex Crisano stays in the game. Si Jun Limpot ang pinalpanit ko si Sunday Salvacion.
So medyo lumiit ng konti. Itong Jin King says, Bal David coming off that pick. Goes for a jumper and it was short but he was fouled. So free throws na naman tayo para kay Bal David. At yung foul ay tinawagan kay Norman Gonzalez. That is his first personal. As Bong Ravenna tries to appeal a case, I don't know what case he's appealing. 3-point lead pa rin ang kalamangan ng Jin Kings. Pick up four.
Bal David, an 83% free throw shooter. Palagay mo, converted kung dalawang to.
Not unless you jinx him. Kasi nangyayari po yun. At malakas ka dun. Pag napapanood kita, magaling ka dun. As you see, Coach Alan Kedic on your screens, raring to get back in the thick of things after the three straight losses.
Last night, Coach Alan Kedic was one of the top 20 PBL players, no?
Aba.
Binigyan ng parangal kagabi yan.
Congratulations.
With the other 19 other PBL players.
Hindi lang natin, siguro maubusan ang laway natin kung mabanggit natin lahat. Pero sa 20 na po yun, ako, congratulations po sa inyo lahat. I'm sure you've made a big mark in basketball history. Here's Asi out to Alapag. Norman Gonzalez driving down the middle. Out to Alapag, the left wing. For three. Book it. And that's the first three-point bomb of the Phone Pals in this game as the score is chopped down. The lead is chopped down to 2 points, 8-6. Eric Meck carving space in the middle. It won't drop. Asi Taulava, strong rebound.
Eric Meck just challenging the defense of Asi Taulava at that time. Asi Taulava holding his own.
Well, Alapag tried to be quick and attempted a bullet pass through the trees. And itong si Eric Meck, nakita to, tapped it away and turnover. At may foul pa. Ito yung drive ni Norman Gonzalez.
Simple drive and draw. Norman Gonzalez being the one to drive and then draw to the wide open. Jimmy Alapag converting a three-pointer.
Another short jumper by Bal David asking for the foul once more. Won't get the benefit of the doubt this time. Asi Taulava goes for three. A little short. Crisano gets that from Salvacion. Sabi niya, akin na lang to pare.
There are some instances where Asi Taulava could hit those three-pointers, pero at that time, oh.
Parang maaga, no?
Oh.
Well, Mark Caguioa says it may be early in our shot clock, but I can drain this jumper as he feels the confidence rolling. Mark Caguioa with his first 2 points of the ball game. 10-6 is our score. 6:43 to go in the first quarter.
The way Mark Caguioa took that shot, no, partner? Na-preach yung defense ni Bong Ravenna.
Yung pasa doon ni Norman Gonzalez was a little behind the cutting Asi Taulava. Meron na kaya nagtanong sa kanya kung bakit siya nagbago ng number?
Sino?
Si Asi.
Oo, alam ko.
Dinagdagan niya ng 33.
Hindi, alam ko lagi ang parang favorite number niya is 10, no? So lahat ng numbers niya, combination, the sum would end up at 10.
Ito, hindi.
No.
The sum is 16.
Oh.
Crisano for a strong offensive rebound. He can't control the leathers. It's tapped from behind, but we got a whistle on the play. And it's going to go against Harvey Carey. As he picks up his first personal foul. At lima na po ang team fouls ng phone fouls. So bakit di pa free throws yun? Shoot on the six.
Ngayon pa lang sila pumasok.
Ngayon pa lang. Nasanay ako sa FIBA eh.
Yun.
For the shoot on the field. Sunday Salvation 4-3. Count that.
You don't allow Sunday Salvation to have an open shot anywhere.
Not the weekend warrior.
Oh.
As you saw on the screen, ang rebounding category natin, lamang doon ang Ginebra, 10-5. And here come the phone fouls in their offensive. Alapag on the right corner gets a screen from Asi Taulava. And he erases Bal David. And that's going to hurt. That's going to leave a mark. Folks, this is your PBA. Says. And our score right now is 13-6 with exactly 6 minutes to go in the first canto. At bola po ng Barangay Ginebra Jenkins. Eric Mink at the right wing looking for some friends. Finds Banjo Calpito who just checked in the ball game. This is Bal David. Salvacion, top of the key. Driving against Gonzalez. Kicking out to Bal David. Drives again. Drops to Eric Mink but can't handle the leather. This is Alapag. Out to Ravenna on the left corner. Nothing doing. Cops out, looks for Asi Taulava against Calpito. Here's the double team. Alapag, down the middle, out to Ravenna. For three, short. And the loose ball goes to Taulava. And he books his field goal easily there after picking up that loose ball.
What a lucky play for Asi Taulava. Bong Ravenna missing a side jumper. And from nowhere, partner, nagulat si Asi Taulava. Nasa harap mo yung bola.
Uy, bola. Akin ito.
Para nakapulot ng piso.
Eric Menk from a step inside the three. And Asi Taulava says, we said.
Oh.
Nakashoot sa akin.
Nandun nga si Asi Taulava right in front of Eric Meng. But Eric Meng had enough space to take that shot.
Bong Ravenna at the post again. We've been familiar with this season. Fade away off the glass. Ayaw pumasok. Eric Meng strong rebound. And here come the Gin Kings.
Sorry miss by Bong Ravenna. At that time, one-on-one against the much smaller Mark Caguioa. Lumabas lang ang bola.
In and out para kay Bong Ravenna. Caguioa to Bal David. Shot clock is down to 10 seconds. Looking for Eric Mink against Carey. Strong fake. Goes up hard with the bump and gets the basket to boot. Pero walang foul doon Eric Mink. Now with 8 points in the ball game, leading all scorers.
Eric Mink just going hard to the basket. Once inside, challenged by Asi Taulava. One pump fake. Kumagat si Asi Taulava. There was contact. Eric Mink made the basket but no foul was called.
Pero yan ang sarap ng may katawan ng katulad ni Eric Mink. Kahit sino bumangga sa'yo, okay ka lang. Norman Gonzalez. Harvey Carey says, babanggin ko kayo lahat. Asi Taulava thought about it. Drives inside. Trickles out. Norman Gonzalez again at the right place at the right time with the right timing. Tapping that miss in.
That's one offensive rebound for Norman Gonzalez plus the putback. You know, yung mga tip-ins na yon, consider that's one offensive
malaking
rebound.
Malaking bagay yun, no? Mautak talaga ito pumesto si Norman Gonzalez. Eric Mink, nice cut. Tap from behind and they will retain possession with 13 on the shot clock. As we've got some substitutions here, Aris Dimonahan comes in para kay Bal David and maya-maya papasok si Patrick Fran at si Mark Telan. Para sa phone pass. At si Mark Talan po, mga kaibigan, ay parang Magic Johnson ng forma dahil meron siyang knee pads. I've never seen this since the 80s.
Alam mo, ito si Aris Dimaunahan, birthday boy ngayon
po. Aba, birthday boy! Ito si Eric Meg, sabi niya, ako rin, pwede makipag-birthday boy dahil 10 puntos na po ako, even with 3:28 to go here in the first quarter. Eric Meg is waxing hot.
The way Eric Meg is playing, it seems that it's his birthday also.
Okay. Pero maganda laro niya ng last game.
Oh.
No? 24-22 ang ginawa niya. 24 points, 22 rebounds.
In a losing effort.
Oh, sayang alam. Nice block by Aris Dimonahan. Oh, sorry. Sunday Salvation.
Sunday Salvation against
blocking,
Norman
Gonzalez.
Gonzalez.
Pareho silang 80. Yung isa, 88. Sunday Salvation with the ball. Finds Mark Caguioa back to Sunday. Looking for Eric Menk against Carey. Fadeaway jumper on the baseline and it won't drop but there's a foul. Natapik sa braso si Eric Menk. And Coach Wolpert is not happy.
And there it goes. Time.
Ito, coach. Tignan nga natin.
Once he gets hold of the ball, quick turnaround. Indeed, there was foul on the arm.
Kahit gaano po kagaang, no matter how light the contact is, no, as long as your skin is touching the... Let's take a look at our outlast batter.
...is looking to win three games in a row for the first time under Coach Wolpert. And the Phone Pals haven't done so since last year's Commissioner's Cup. During the timeout, he was quick to remind the Phone Pals to keep an eye on the guys scoring right now on the Kings side, like Sunday Salvacion and, of course, Eric Menk. Back to you, TJ, and Coach Leo.
Thanks, Patricia. And, of course, Coach Wolpert, not a happy man at this moment. You can see it pa lang dahil naputi siya, so namumula-mula siya ng konti. Rosy cheeks.
Napapainitan ng mga referees eh.
At yung technical free throw po kanina ay naipasok ni Mark Caguioa. And now, Eric Mech books his first free throw. So adding on to this lead, it's now 21-10. As coach, meron tayong field goal numbers.
Talk and text converting only 4 of 16 attempts while Barangay Ginebra shooting 50%, 7 of 14.
So far, still, ball game is... Side kicking out, lob pass to Martelan, can't handle it completely. Back to Gonzalez, 8-foot jumper is good.
He had a chance to score a while ago, single coverage against Sunday Salvacion, but he elected to make a lob pass outside to Martelan. Buti na lang, binalik ni Martelan yung bola sa kanya for a soft jumper.
Ako, binalik naman ni Aris Dimonahan sa phone pass. Here come the phone pass, Asi Taulava trying to do a facial slam on Aris Dimonahan. Just could not get the dunk to stay. Eric Menk against Martelan, and he gets that to drop. Eric Menk is a man possessed, 14 points. And we're not even done with the first quarter yet. Meron pa tayong 2:03 to go. Aba si Eric Menk talagang may balak na ulitin yung ginawa niya na last
year. Meron talaga, no? Power move.
Jimmy Alapag getting the shooter's bounce for three.
A second three-pointer by Jimmy Alapag. Mm-hmm. They have to stay close against Jimmy Alapag's jumper. Alam natin, maliit na player to, pero can shoot the lights out.
24-15 is our score. Alapag with a second triple, already with 6 points. Menk taking a pass, driving inside. Goes hard against Mark Delan. Somebody falls. Calpito says, akin na to, mga kaibigan, and he books his 2 points.
A case of being at the right place at the right time. Banjo Calpito getting 2 points. Nawala na yung depensa, totally.
Balik ang kalamangan sa 11 para sa Ginebra. Telan out to Patrick Fran. To Norman Gonzalez, right wing. A little strong. Loose ball foul somewhere, somehow, on somebody. And that somebody is gonna be...
Banjo Calpito.
Banjo Calpito. Huli ka.
Well, Barangay Ginebra not yet over team penalty, so they could afford to give up those fouls. Only their fourth team foul with a minute and 15 seconds left dito sa ating first quarter.
Meron tayong substitutions. Bumalik sa ball game itong si
Cahibilla
naman at si Elmer Lago para sa Ginebra. Alapag down the right side, hanging in the air, finding nobody to pass to but the Araneta mop man.
Cahibilla called off the bench. The pass was intended to him, pero sometimes, partner, no, 10 minutes ka nang nakaupo dito sa first quarter, pagpasok mo sa loob, talagang yung hands mo hindi pa ready to get those passes.
That's right. Salvacion from three. A little long. I mean, a little way out there, so it was short.
Not a good shot selection. It's a good thing they got the possession back.
Sloppy pass there by Salvacion, tapped out by the little big man, Cahivilla.
They're having some troubles trying to beat the 2-3 zone defense of Talk and Text.
Maganda yung tatapik ng Talk and Text yung mga passing lane kasi, no? Natatakpan nila eh. So far, this defense of Talk and Text is doing some damage, pero lamang pa rin ang Ginebra ng 11.
Well, at times kanina, no, they were playing man-to-man and lumamang ng 12 points itong Barangay Ginebra. So why not convert to a 2-3 zone defense?
Correct. Bumalik sila sa 2-3 zone and that did wonders for them there as they got the defensive stop. Short yung jumper ni Jun Limpot at yung loose ball, eh, nag-out of bounds na lang. Possession goes back to the boys in blue. Here's Jimmy Alapag trying to set things up again for the phone foul. He's got 6 points in the game. Gets two screens at the top of the key. Pulls up and he gets a maganda shooter's bounce here to Jimmy Alapag.
He's been hitting those kinds of play and Aris Dimonahan has to do something, partner. No, why not just tail Jimmy Alapag? Instead, ginagawa ni Aris Dimonahan. He's trying to play Jimmy Alapag going way below the screeners.
Coach, ano mas maiging gagawin niya? Labanan na lang niya over the top yung screen.
Over the top or tail him.
Lalo niya didikitan para hindi mapul yung double screen. Pero so far nga, medyo last play, nahirapan si Aris kasi nga, dalawang screen Sa dalawang malalaking screen yun, merong isang screen kay Asi at yun yung pangalawa kay Martin. And here's that last play, fouled in the act of shooting si main man Jun Limpot as he'll troop to the line. Speaking of Jun Limpot, Coach Leo, itong sinabi nga natin, si Jun Limpot started the season like a house on fire, averaging 28.5 points, pero in his last three games, eh, medyo bumaba ang kanyang average.
Oo, oh, sabihin na natin, nagka-inabot ng si Jun Limpot ng low-up averages,
Boon.
Having averaged so much in the first two games, but during the last three games, na natalo sila, eh, talagang inabot na siya. Or maybe sabihin na natin, na-scout na sa si Jun Limpot. Now, other teams who have beaten Barangay Ginebra in the last three games have prepared well against Jun Limpot,
correct,
considering na talagang grabe ang linaro nito in the first two games.
Right, we're gonna check this out. Here's Asi Taulava in the paint, trying to beat the buzzer, and it won't drop as the end of... Please do stick around. This is going to be a very exciting... Kaibigan, at kung sa tingin nyo, sa hard court lang may action, nagkakamali kayo. As you see Eric McGrain, that tough shot in the face of Mark Dilanaco. At habang may action sa court, yan ang action sa crowd. Another mismo moment brought to you by Coca-Cola. Coach, interesting yung matchup natin ng big men, pero so far it's been the big man of Ginebra doing the damage, specifically a guy named Eric Menk.
Eric Menk against the whole Talk and Text team, 14 points, 6 rebounds, while the whole Talk and Text team during the first quarter, 17 points and
Aba,
10 rebounds.
Kinaya niya mag-isa, no?
Oo. Oh. Sabi mo nga kanina eh, playing like a man possessed, Eric Menk.
Yep.
Parang birthday boy din eh.
Well, as we said earlier, Eric Menk is coming off a spectacular ball game. Unfortunately, it was for a loss against the Tigers. He had 24 points in this ball game with 8 points, 2 of them 3-point shots. Pero yung dalawa doon, eh, medyo may konting awa ng halo, no? Awa at swerte.
Hindi,
with the shooter's bounce.
Pag magaling ka, madalas kang swerte.
At maganda ka mag-backspin. Tulad mo!
Yun.
Tira mo dati, hindi ko magaya-gaya eh. Ito si Sante Salmosyon. Gagayahin kaya niya, hindi niya magaya. Rebound by Patrick Fran. Here come the phone fouls running. Delan on the left wing. Stops and pops. Going glass. Won't go. Lago to Dimaunahan. In the middle of the pack. Out to Lago. Nice pass inside to Limpot, who's got good position, but he finds a big guy in front of him in the name of Asi Taulava. Medyo na ilang siya doon.
Good entry pass by Lago to Jun Limpot. Dumulas lang yung bola kay Jun Limpot.
Mark Talan, a step inside the three, and he drains that jumper. And he is helping the phone pals chop down the Ginebra lead down to 9, 28 to 19.
What confidence for Mark Talan. He missed his first shot on the return play partner. Bumitaw na naman.
Correct. At speaking of bumibitaw, ito si Elmer Lago, bumitaw din ng maagang tres, pero ayaw pumasok. Medyo up-tempo ang ating aksyon ngayon, mga kaibigan. Jimmy Alapag driving hard against Elmer Lago as he gets a foul. And they're not that patient to start the second quarter. They want to get scoring.
Especially for Barangay Ginebra. We saw some shots of Sunday Salvacion and Lago taken too early in their possession.
Oh.
Not enough ball movement on the part to try to test the defense of Talk and Text. Well, as we have said earlier, Talk and Text has converted to a 2-3 zone defense. So talagang medyo nangangapa yung opensa ng Barangay Ginebra pag nakita nila yung dalawang defenders sa harap and yung tatlo sa ilalim.
Nandalaki yung mata ng wingman kapag libre, no?
Oo.
As Jimmy Alapag rattles out his first free throw. At itong si Jimmy Alapag, so far his free throw numbers have been quite good. 85% actually ang naitikira ni Jimmy Alapag, but he misses both. At nung pagkakataong yun, hindi ikaw nag-jig sa kanya.
Ikaw yun.
Ako yun. Akong nagbanggit. Always happens to the best of them. And this is Kahi Villa inbounding as they retain possession. Delan with the ball, fakes out to Alapag. Shot clock is still fresh at 19. Alapag hard down the middle against Eric Menk. At meron pa rin shooter's bounce. Ano ba nakain mo, Jimmy Alapag? Pahingi naman yan. At magandang iyong shooter's bounce today.
Well, the way Jimmy Alapag attacks Sunday Salvacion defense partner, no? Wala lang magagawa yung help defense dahil nakabuelo na talaga itong si Jimmy Alapag.
At malakas tumalon yung batang yan. Here's a jumper by Limpot. A little too strong, and Alapag again with the ball. Lob pass to Asi Taulava. Fake. And he puts it right in the hole. As here come the Talk and Text phone pals. Up and running. Fully charged sa buong kanilang baterya after that. Time now for our Merrill getaway move. And here is Jimmy Alapag driving hard, leaving Salvacion to eat his dust, and just goes around Eric Menk. Talk about elevation and the awa, the shooter's bounce. That getaway move was brought to you by Merrill Performance Footwear. Getaway to adventure with Merrill USA. Welcome back to the Big Dome, mga kaibigan. TJ Manotok po with Coach Leo Isak and with Patricia Bermudez at the sidelines. Over NBN4, this is your PBA. And Coach Tokentex, may maagal run, ano?
6-0 run by Tokentex. And the bear birthday boy, Aris Dimaunan, hitting a three-pointer.
Happy birthday to you, Aris Dimaunan. At nakabawi ka agad yung 6-0 run. Ginawa nila niyang 6-3.
Good timeout by Coach Alan Kaidik.
Asi Taulava finds a lot of white shirts. Out to Martelan for a long jumper. It won't fall. Eric Mek boxed out Asi Taulava for the rebound. This is Dimaunan calling his boys to set up the play. Mek open in the middle. Ball fake. Loses the leather in the midair.
Eric Mek not happy with that referee's partner. Ooh. No fouls being called in that last play.
Patrick Brand tees up a three. It won't drop. Kahi Villa quick to the loose ball as he gets that offensive rebound against Dimaunan. And Aris, the birthday boy, will be called for a foul.
Foul number 88.
31-23 po mga kaibigan ang score natin. 9:37 to go here in the second period. Still pretty much in control of the Gin Kings.
Partner Coach Alan Kaidik being forced to call a timeout a while ago because of that 6-0 run by Tokentex. Good enough on the return play after the timeout. Kumauna kaagad ito si Aris Dimaunan. Three-pointer pa.
Correct. Here's Mark Delan from the left wing, going glass a little too strong. Mark Caguioa with the rebound, looking ahead, can't find the big man, finds Elmer Lago instead. And Lago goes for three. It's too long. Open. Maaga pa rin mga tap nila.
Correct, no? Open jumper, no? For a shooter like Elmer Lago, there's no maaga, partner. Pag na-libre yan, bibitawan talaga niyan.
Ito, Asi Taulava, gustong malibre at tinulak si Eric Mink. At nako, not good news for the phone bounce, because that is going to be Asi Taulava's third personal foul.
Eric Menk played Asi Taulava very well in that last sequence, denying the ball. Asi Taulava wanting to get that ball instead. Natawagan siya na offensive foul.
Eric Menk in the middle, driving down hard, and uses the glass against Asi Taulava.
A hole in the zone defense of the Tokentex phone foul partner. Eric Menk just having an easy time.
So coach, so far maganda yun talaga yung timing ng cut ni Meg. Nakakahanap siya ng butas. Patrick Fran to Asi Taulava gets a double team. Alapag wide open for three, and he drains it again. Jimmy Alapag is really carrying the scoring cudgels for the phone fouls. He now has 13 big points, 13 of the 26 of the phone fouls. He's keeping them in this game.
Jimmy Alapag just having a good day here at the Araneta Coliseum. Partner, napakaliit pero ang gandang maglaro.
Speaking of maliit na maglaro, nako, Kahi Villa, hindi maganda ang layup. Too strong. Here's Jun Limpot from 17 feet. He drains the jumper. And he once again puts the lead of the Gin Kings up a little bit more to 9 points, 35-26. 8:03 to go in the second quarter. At yung pace talaga ng ball game natin ay up tempo.
Sorry missed by Kahi Villa a while ago.
Alapag for a long three. It's a little off to the right. Battle for the rebound. That may foul na naman tayo as Kahi Villa tried to keep that ball alive for the phone bounce. The foul though will go against Mark Caguioa. His second team, his second personal foul. And we've got a three-man substitution para sa phone bounce. Pumasok si Carey, si Gonzalez,
Don Belbelano.
At pinaupo si Telan, Fran, at si Asi Taulava, who has three personal fouls, and we might see him. Baka second half pa yan. This is Norman Gonzalez, Kahi Villa. Very small lineup for the phone fouls in the court right now. Carey for a jumper from 14 feet. A little short.
And you mentioned it correctly. Very small lineup for the phone fouls at that time. No second serving. And with a small lineup that they have inside, Jun Limpot just attacks the defense. Nobody could match up against the likes of Jun Limpot and Eric Mek.
Lamang na lamang sila sa height ngayon dyan at Eric Menk and Jun Limpot. As you see so far tonight, Jimmy Alapag, aba 13 points already, just a pinch of salt away from his 16.75 average. As Jun Limpot right now on the stripe, not shy kasi nga maliit ang kanyang mga bantay at pumipihit ng maaga, and he books his first free throw. Balik sa 10 ang kalamangan ng Gin Kings. 7:31 to go in our second quarter. Thanks for joining us again, folks. This is the PBA. Ang game ninyo over NBN 4. Jun Limpot with 7 points tonight. Make that 8. Make that 7 again kasi binawi dahil merong lane violation. Someone stepped on the line.
The shooter?
Early, the shooter.
Oh, pare, very rare na ngayon yung mga ganong klaseng tawag.
Oh, ano? Well, his right big toe was stepping on the line just a little bit. Kahi Villa finds Belano. Belano pops up a three in front of Elmer Lago.
Called off the bench. Oh. Don Bel Belano taking a three-pointer, partner. Yun ang kumpiyansa.
Yun ang kumpiyansa. Ito rin. May kumpiyansa rin ito. Sunday Salvation. Cross-court to Elmer Lago. One up for three. Nice pass inside to Jun Limpot. Great pass. Great positioning by the main man.
Jun Limpot just having a good pass coming from Lago and with no Asi Taulava, no Mark Telan to challenge him. Partner, halos sigurado na yung mga ganong klaseng tira.
Yan ang problema. Sabi mo nga, Coach Leo, yung big men nakawalan sa loob ng zone ng phone pals as another miss here by the pals. Rebound.
Also on the part of the on the offensive side of the talk and text phone pals, pag nag-miss sila, partner, halos
wala
one
na,
shot
no?
lang, no?
Oh.
Wala nang second serving because nobody would get those offensive rebounds.
Well, we've got a call on the play. It looks like, ah, sabi na nga ba eh, basa ko na sa dito. 3 seconds daw ang tinawag kay Eric Menk as bumauna siya ng bahay dun sa paint.
At that time, masyadong matagal yung bola bago dumating kay Eric Menk. And with the mismatch that he has against Harvey Carey, talagang
sayang.
Bumabad na siya sa shaded area.
Two screens again for Jimmy Alapag. He fakes off Bal David. Pero masama ang kanyang angulo dun sa kanyang pabanda. And here comes the Gin Kings. Bal David kicks out to Salvacion. Tapped out though by Norman Gonzalez. Pero kanina po yun, Coach, gumana nung first time yung double high screen para kay Alapag. At talagang mahirap bantayan if you're the point guard, no? You see two big men right in front of you.
Well, kanina, first quarter, meron, sabihin na natin, very fresh pa si Jimmy Alapag. Oh. Pero ngayon, no? Second quarter na, hindi pa nagpapahinga to. Sigurado ako, iba na ang pulso nito.
Good point.
Iba na rin ang legs nito.
Speaking of pulso, malakas yung pulso doon ni Salvacion. Pero yung pulso naman ni Belano, sabi niya, eto na, okay na ako. Nakabanat na ako na isa. Yung pangalawa ko, eh, swak na po mga kaibigan. As he puts the lead down again to 10 points. I'd like to remind you folks that Timex is the official timer of the PBA games. Eric Menk losing the leather on the baseline.
Sorry, play. No? Almost a completed play. Kung nakuha lang ni Eric Menk yung handoff na yun ni Jun Limpot. No? Well-executed play. Trying to beat the 2-3 zone defense. That's one way of trying to beat the 2-3 zone defense. No? Send cutters. Hit those cutters inside.
Change me, sabi ni Norman Gonzalez as trying to drive but kicks it out. Alapag. Stops on a dime, out to Gonzalez, out to Belano, driving baseline, going around the world, and there is an offensive foul on Kahi Villa as he set up a very wide but illegal screen. Sarap ng kalaparan ito, no?
Tawag ko dyan si ano eh, Baby Ali Pick.
Baby Ali Pick. Pwedeng sa lapad niya, pwedeng landingan ng aeroplano. Here's Bal David looking for Elmer Lago, trying to look for Eric Menk, but a nice coverage by Harvey Carey. Bal David pulls up a jumper just inside the three, rims out, at may rebound ni Gonzalez, but there's a foul somewhere. It's against Eric Menk, and that's going to be only his first personal foul, but it is the 15th foul of the Gin Kings, so medyo maaga sila makakapasok sa penalty, Coach Leo, dahil meron pa tayong 5 minutes dito sa ating first half.
Oh, and the next foul to be called against the Gin Kings partner. 2 free throws, a chance for Talk and Text to come back in this game.
Alapag once again using his speed, and there's a foul on the play as Elmer Lago tried to take the charge, but the foul is on Bal David naman, hand-checking foul. At mukhang
eto na ang iniintay ni Coach Paul Wolpert, the penalty situation for the Barangay Ginebra Kings.
Masakit na to.
Jimmy Alap
have difficult assignments in their hands right now. Coach Allen earlier urged his players to have more movement, be more aggressive, and make sure to get those rebounds. That's probably why the Kings right now are holding on to this lead. Back to you, TJ, and Coach Leo.
Thanks, Patricia, and you are so right. Definitely Asi Taulava is the biggest thorn on the side of the Gin Kings, especially ngayon, medyo hindi sila kasing lalim as normal. Wala nga si Rommel Adducul.
Correct. And with still 4 minutes and 57 seconds left dito sa ating second quarter, Jimmy Alapag canning in both free throws because Barangay Ginebra over the foul limit na.
Oh,
a big chance for Token Tex to make a comeback in this game.
That early penalty situation will be a factor here in the second quarter as we have a foul in the play. And Mark Delan is going to be called for this one. And he has his work cut out for him as he is trying to guard Eric Menk, who is probably, give or take, heavier than him by about 30 or 40 pounds.
But Mark Delan now knows how to play Eric Menk, having been his teammate
before
in their PBL days.
Pati sa PBL ba nag-aabot sila?
Nag-aabot yan, magkakampiyan.
Sa stag pala. Well, here's Salvacion inside to Limpot. Cross-court to Bal David. Cross-court again to Sunday Salvacion. Quickly rotating ang defense ng Phone Pals. And there's another 3-second call. Coach Deo, magandang rotation
correct,
ng Phone Pals,
no? With only 3 seconds left on the shot clock of Barangay Ginebra partner, medyo overstaying na naman sa shaded area itong Barangay Ginebra Kings. Natawagan sila ng 3-second violation. And the way the Token Tex has tightened up their defense, maganda ang naging resulta.
Well, even with the height discrepancy, the Phone Pals playing pretty decent zone defense for themselves. Here's Pelano. Pops a 3 in front of the face of Mark Caguioa. Harvey Carey, big rebound, big assist pass to Norman Gonzalez. And don't look now, folks, because the Phone Pals are back in the thick of things. They're only down by 6, 38-32.
And selfish play on the part of Harvey Carey, issuing a pass to Norman Gonzalez, although metira na siya after getting that offensive rebound.
Oh, talk about nice passes. Nice pass by Mark Caguioa inside to Sunday Salvation, threading the needle there. Was Mark the spark showing us Mame passing skills din ako.
Oh, talaga naman eye contact lang between the two players, Sunday Salvation and Mark Caguioa. Partner, ngayon lang nagkasama yan.
And Harvey Carey gets blocked by Eric Meg, tries to go for second servings. He taps the ball out as it's gonna go back to the Phone Pals.
Physical play being shown by Harvey Carey and Eric Meg at that time. No fouls were called, although Harvey Carey indeed initiated contact.
Ito siguro ang dalawang player sa PBA na grabe yung sculpted bodies nila, no?
Kita mo, pag nagbabangga, kumikislap
Lumiliyap. Ito, Eric Meg spinning baseline, going hard to the hoop with the left hand, and he gets the friendly bounce against the whole team of the Phone Pals, taking them all on as Eric Meg is really scoring very well here in the first half. He already has 18 points as Jimmy Alapag again using his speed, picking up a foul, and again, Coach Leo, penalty ang Ginebra. Alapag will go to the line.
Wise play by Jimmy Alapag. Again, that high pick and roll for him this time. Bal David tried to follow him, but Jimmy Alapag, using his shoulder, had inside positioning, was bumped by Bal David. Now will take 2 free throws. Partner, sabi sa'yo kanina, nobody could match up against the speed of this guy, Jimmy Alapag.
Mm-hmm. So, Coach Leo, kung ganun nga yung situation ni Coach Alan Kedik, do you think it would be time for them to maybe double-team him early to give up the ball since he's keeping on driving and keeping getting the fouls?
Good point, TJ. Good no, Barangay Ginebra already in team penalty. Partner, they could try to convert to a 2-3 zone defense, sure. Di ba?
Para hindi naman sila mapenetrate ng ganun kadali with Jimmy Alapago. So far, it's only been the Phone Pals who have opted to try the 2-3 zone, and the Gin Kings have stuck to their man-to-man D as they still enjoy this 8-point lead with 3 and 10 to go in the first half. Here's Bal David, throw the shot back inside to Menk, tapped away by Mark Dillon. Here's Alapag racing against everybody and says, walang asing bilis ko sa PBA. Grabe.
Just awesome. Jimmy Alapag, court to court after getting that pass from Mark Dillon, challenging the defense of Mark Caguioa. And you say you are the spark, I am Jimmy Alapag.
Grabe. Kung ikaw spark ka lang, ako bullet train, sabi ni Jimmy Alapag. The fastest thing on land so far tonight has been Jimmy Alapag.
And the way he's being utilized by Coach Paul Wolpert, wala pang pahinga ito si Jimmy Alapag.
Sa payon, well, Jimmy Alapag has turned on the after boosters and has got his second. At kung sa tingin niyo po ay sa hardcourt lang may action, nakakamali kayo. Here's Jimmy Alapag turning on the after boosters. At habang may action sa court, yan ang action sa crowd. Yan ang peaceful moment brought to you by Coca-Cola. 2:47 to go, and Bal David is now at the stripe for a pair of free throws. Very interesting, Coach Leo. Eh, nasa harapan natin yun si Mark Caguioa.
He's asking the commissioner.
For an older ball.
Oo. Oh,
kasi dahil, sabi niya madulas daw itong bagong bola.
Correct. Talagang madulas siya, no? Especially na hindi pinagamit sa warm-ups. Siguro, baka galing pa to sa box mismo.
Pare, no?
Madulas na madulas siya,
galing
no?
Galing pa sa box, eh, tas bagong
kanina
bomba
lang in-inflate yan. Naalala ko, NCAA days, talagang ganyan. Bagong bola, dulasan ng dulasan, no?
Dulasan. Oh, ayan na naman, no? May punto si Mark Caguioa.
Tama.
Nadulas ang bola kay Mark Dilan at sabi niya, ball boy, pahingi pa nga ng isa pang galon ng pro grip.
Akala ko, nadulas kay Mark Dilan yung bola. Oh, repalta natin yung bola dahil possession namin.
Kailangan niya na isang galon dahil ganun kalaki ang kamay niya. And here's Mark Caguioa saying, I'll do my best with this slippery ball. Eric Menk, Mark Dilan all over him like a jockstrap. Mark Caguioa, 4-3, drains it.
Nagre-reklamo pa yan. Madulas ang bola.
May angle yan. Mark Dilan says, babawi ako agad. Ayaw yung kanyang running jumper off the glass. Mark Dilan missing that. And Milano with the rebound. Alapag thought about it. Out to Milano. And he drains a jumper from 20 feet.
Unselfish play by Jimmy Alapag. Doing everything. Scoring at that time. Issuing an assist to the wide open Don Bel Belano.
Ang bilis talaga ng action natin, mga kaibigan. Very quick pace being shown by both teams as... It's been rare that we have seen a 24-second violation, if any. Parang wala pa, no?
Wala pa.
Jun Limpot making Harvey Carey off. Gets his own miss, going strong. Mark Dilan fouls him from behind.
Harvey Carey not knowing the moves of Jun Limpot, partner. Isang kindat lang ni Jun Limpot, kumagat kagad sa pick. At that time, na-miss pa nga ni Jun Limpot. Pero second serving, may foul na.
I like that. Isang kindat lang.
Oo, oh, partner.
Ito yung kindat, mga kaibigan.
Kindat.
Wala ka na.
Kita mo, naalala mo yung player ng papa mo dati?
Sino?
Si Bog sa Tornado.
Oo, oh, magaling kumindat yun.
Pag kinindatan ka nun, kakagat ka ta.
Kakagat ka talaga. Yung kanyang ball fixing, sing-simpi na isang kindat. And here's Jun Limpot at the foul line, trickles in for his first free throw, ups the lead to 46-38. And our pace has been so quick, so fast for both teams that I'm having to catch my breath.
Para with the likes of Mark Caguioa, Jimmy Alapag, Bal David, Don Belano, mabilis talaga
ang laro ito. Nako, huwag ka nang umangal, DJ, at yan ang exciting na basketball. 47-38 is our score. 1:30 to go in the first half. Here's Don Del Verano, TZ up the three. A little long, Mark Dilan, Eric Menk with a quick rebound. Good boxing out.
Malaki na, marunong pampungwesto. What else can you ask for? Eric Menk getting another defensive rebound.
And Eric Menk has been the main man on the offense at the Chinggis, but that time, good timing by Mark Dilan as he blocks the shot. Here's Alapag. Driving down the middle, kicking out to nobody, but getting bailed out by Sunday Salvation as he taps that ball out. Yung 80 talaga doon, nagbumukha 88 sa akin sa malayo eh.
Corner at that time, Jimmy Alapag. So at a fast break situation where they had only two players against three defenders of Ginebra. So he decided to kick it out. Natapik lang nito si Sunday Salvation.
Milano ball fake, driving middle. Nice floater. And Harvey Carey, hard-working Harvey Carey off the glass, tips it in. Good positioning against Eric Menk.
Partner, hard-working Harvey Carey, pero nobody boxing him out at that last rebound play. So talagang makakakuha ng offensive rebound yan.
Aris Dimaunahan looking for something to do with the ball. Driving down the middle, gets the foul from Jimmy Alapag, who, as you mentioned, ay wala pa pong pahinga ito.
Alapag. Aris Dimaunahan trying to test the defense of Jimmy Alapag. Maganda ka mag-create, maganda ka magdala ng bola. Subukan ko ang depensa mo at that time, naisa ni Aris Dimaunahan ito. Foul si Jimmy Alapag. Pero since talk and text not yet over team penalty, sideline out of bounds lang tayo dito.
At sinubukan din niya kung pagod na siya. Sabi niya, siguro pagod na to eh. Baka madaanan ko na madali. Well, sidelines inbound for the Jin Kings. Salvacion for a quick three.
Not the play they want, partner.
Maybe
too early. I saw Coach Alan K. Dick.
Not happy. Here's Don Dale Belano from the corner out to Alapag. Trying to trim down the shot clock. Crossover dribble, driving right past Dimaunahan. Big rebound though by Alex Pisano.
Everything but the basket for Jimmy Alapag.
17 seconds to go
last
in the
shot.
First half. and Aris Dimonan says, referee, timeout muna kami so we can set up a nice last
room with a 9-point cushion. Partner, pagbalik mo sa third quarter, ang sarap ng pakiramdam.
Correct.
Niyan.
Malaking bagay yan. Pero, ang inaasahan naman ng phone pals is to have a defensive stop, go into the dugout with 7 points lang ang kalamangan ng Gintis. At babalik si Asi Taulava pa mamaya.
Yun, no.
Kasi he has 3 fouls right now. Jun Limpot having a hard time to inbound the ball and he gets called for a very rare 5-second violation. And Asi Taulava is on his feet applauding his teammates for good denial defense there.
Now it's coping
about these last 14 seconds of our first half. Mon Ravenna inbounding quickly to Dondel Bilano. At sa wakas, pinagpahinga nila si Alapag. Bilano.
1-4. Situation for Dondel Bilano.
Second the clock. Tees up on three. Short to the left, but Harvey Carey, as we said, the epitome of hard work. Gets another offensive rebound.
And with Barangay Ginebra over team penalty, it would mean 2 free throws for Harvey Carey. So sabi mo nga, may magandang mangyayari in that last play and a good timeout being called by Coach Paul Wolpert. A chance for Talk and Text.
Oh no!
Ay, teka lang!
Halika muna!
Apa?
Paliktan, look at Coach Paul Wolpert!
Apa.
Not happy with the call.
Wait a second, wait a minute, folks. The foul, apparently, was called against Harvey Carey.
Oh, partner, maganda makita siguro natin yung last play na yun.
Oh. Ito, yung mintis ni Bilano.
A slight push. Naka-extend na talaga yung right hand niya, no? At going for the loose ball, parang nandun si Alex Crisano.
Actually, ang ginawa po ito ni Harvey Carey, eh, chinecheck po niya kung si Crisano ay may ginamit na deodorant. Kasi nandun sa kilikili eh. Pero baka kaya yung foul eh, dahil may hinugot siyang buhok at nasaktan si Crisano, hindi naman siguro. May konti siguro ng tulak na nakita ang referee. And here's a long pass to Carey, losing the leather, and there's still 0.3 left on the clock.
Enough.
It's a 9-point lead for the Gin Kings as Crisano booked the 2 free throws.
Enough time for one catch and shoot play.
Pwede ito, no, with 0.3. Ito
oh, playable.
Oh, catch and shoot dapat ito. Jun Limpot turning around, putting it up. And that will not count even if it had gone in. And our halftime score, mga kaibigan, 49-40 in favor of the back to the Big Dome, mga kaibigan. The resumption of action here at the Araneta Coliseum between the Ginebra Gin Kings and the Talk and Text phone pass. Still a 9-point lead being enjoyed by Ginebra, 49-40, amidst the absence of Rommel Adducul, who just graduated today, as a nice jumper by Bal David to start off the scoring here in our second half.
Well-executed half-court offense on the part of Barangay Ginebra. Bal David using double screens to free himself up and converting that jumper on top of the key.
Inside to Asi Taulava, who is back in the ballgame after sitting out a long period for his 3 personal fouls. A long 3-point shot by Norman Gonzalez, who was wide open there. He drained that after the kickout from Asi Taulava. Lead is chopped down to 8.
Well, Barangay Ginebra allowing Norman Gonzalez to take that 3-pointer, knowing that he has not been shooting quite well from the field.
Jun Limpot at the post against Carey. Nice spin inside. Kinindata na naman.
Oh, Jun Limpot just teaching the rookie, Harvey Carey, how it is done underneath.
Oh, bata, ganito lang yung kindatan dito sa PBA. Asi Taulava takes a jumper, takes it anyways, and he drains that in the face of Alex Crisano.
And that's one good sign for Coach Paul Wolpert. Asi Taulava back here in the third quarter, converting his first attempt.
And Asi Taulava only with 4 points in the ballgame, as we sat out a long time. Bounce a bit strong to the hoop, floating that over Norman Gonzalez and using the glass as the Gin Kings offense continuing to pound inside against the defense of the phone fouls. Well, ginawa nila yun ng first half dahil maliit yung lineup ng Talk and Text. Hindi naman, bumalik na si Asi.
Oh, flashes of the old Bal David. Mm. The flash.
The prime of Bal David. Pero sabi niya, meron pa. I still have some prime time left in me.
Meron pa. Oh.
Sideline inbound para sa phone fouls. Here's Taulava going baseline. Out to Gonzalez, out to Alapag. Sabi niya, back to you, pare ko. Isa pang tres dyan at isa pa nga ang binigay ni Norman Gonzalez. Back-to-back 3-point bombs by Gonzalez.
Why not take another one? I hit one earlier. Mm. So, bakit hindi? Mainit pa.
Oh, sabi niya, I can feel it. Feel niya.
And the way he took that shot, no, partner, it's not a jump shot.
ano, a spot-up shooter.
Kumpiyansa, sabi ni Bal David, ako rin may kumpiyansa, kaso walang 3 points na pumasok doon. Here come the phone pals. Alapag, out to Ravenna. Why not another three-pointer? Pero ayaw. At rebound kay David, quickly out to Mark Aguiba for the easy layup. And fast break na naman para sa Ginebra.
Good recognition on the part of Bal David, realizing lalibing libre si Mark Aguiba for that forward pass. Nobody contesting Mark Aguiba for 2 points. There's the double.
Alapag from the kick out. Another three-pointer. Apa! Nakatato na po na tres itong phone fouls to start the third period. And don't look now, they are doing their job of chopping this lead down. Anim na lang po ang kalamangan ng Ginebra with 9:07 to go in our third quarter.
The recent partner, the noble team ng Barangay Ginebra, si Asi Taulava. So kick out to the wide open Jimmy Alapag, three-pointer pa.
So malaking bagay yung pagbabalik ni Asi Taulava. His mere presence on the court is doing something, even if he's not scoring, di ba? Na-attack yung defense eh.
And he's contented in the past two games na nagpapanalo sila, no? Medyo behind the limelight ng konti, no? He's been rebounding, he's been defending, issuing assists to his teammates. So talagang ini-involve ni Asi yung kanyang mga teammates. Hindi niya kinukuha lahat ng trabaho.
Rex, speaking of teammates who's in trouble now, Alapag has 4 fouls. That's why Bal David trying to get his fifth. Cristiano with a big rebound and the putback in the face of Asi Taulava. No fear there. Para kay Cristiano, walang takot siya doon sa malalaking tao na phone balls. Here's Taulava attracting the crowd. Gonzalez again for three. He was wide open but this time won't drop.
Diretso ang tira ni Norman Gonzalez. Medyo kapos nga lang ang release.
Cristiano open but won't take that. Into Eric Menk against Carey. Menk is the top scorer so far for the Ginkings with 18 points. Spinning baseline. Difficult shot of the left hand. And Cristiano keeping the ball alive. First shot clock para sa Ginkings. Here's Caguioa using the screen of Eric Meck. Tees up a three. Oops! Not that time. Blocked by Carey.
Still with 14 seconds left on the shot clock. Maaga pa to.
Jun Limpot will try to do something about it. Goes baseline. Goes reverse. Blocked again. This time by Gonzalez. And Eric Meck at the right place at the right time. And he puts the Ginkings up again by 10 points.
And you have to give credit to the defense of Token Tex at that time, blocking 2 shots from different players. Pero sabi nga natin, yung bagsak ng bola at the last play, yun ang importante.
Taulava again attracting a lot of white shirts like an ant with chocolate. Long in the jump shot. Here's Caguioa. Picking up speed. Inside to Eric Meck. Gorgeous pass. But he just can't get the layup to drop. Diving for the loose ball. But Eric Meck showing the hustle. But maybe a little too much hustle there as he hit the steel chairs of the Araneta bench.
Partner, give credit also to Asi Taulava's defense. This was a very good pass by Mark Aguiwa. But look at Asi Taulava coming from nowhere. Kahit konti, na-intimidate si Eric Meng. Nagbago yung tiro, nagtira.
Oo, natulas ng konti at may kasamang intimidation ng The Rock. Here's Carey. Sabi niya, I'll take a three. Everybody's hitting it anyways. I'll take mine.
Poor defense on the part of Barangay Ginebra. They've been allowing a lot of three-pointers in this fourth and this third quarter.
Ano ba nakain ng Tokitex nung halftime? Puro tres. They probably ate 3 burgers each. And here come the phone pals. Quickly, Alapag tries to go to Gonzalez but Mark again with a quick tap. Pero kahit maraming tres ang phone pals, lamang pa rin ng pito itong Ginebra.
It was a 9-point lead before we started this third period. And from the way it is going, possession ng Barangay Ginebra, 7 points down. Points in the paint, Ginebra 10. Talk and text, nothing.
Pero may apat silang tres. Here's Carey in the paint. Ball fake and aray po po. Nasakit naman ng mintis.
Partner, he had an opening pero with the presence of Jun Limpot, ayaw niya. No? Natakot siya.
Pero bumawi naman si Harvey Carey with the steal from behind Eric Meck. Here's Alapag. Thought about a three, driving inside, spinning around. And there's a foul.
The hesitation move of Jimmy Alapag. Medyo nawala sa defensive stance si Bal David.
Matataranta ka talaga sa bilis nitong si Jimmy Alapag. As he picked up the foul against Bal David, and that is going to be Bal David's third personal foul at pangalawang team foul ng Barangay Ginebra. It's Bong Ravenna getting a screen from Harvey Carey. Alapag, left wing inside to the Rock. Against two defenders, short. Limpot for the rebound, and so far
good defense on the part of Barangay Ginebra. They've been doubling Asi Taulava from the blind side. So once he makes the third, nandun na yung help defense.
Sabi ni Bal David, ako naman, pasubok ng 3 points, pwede. At pumasok din with the shooter's bounce, and they're asking if it's gonna count. There's a loose ball foul. Ano ba, counted? Okay.
The shot will count, but there was a play simultaneous to the basket.
Ah, counted, pero may loose ball foul kay
Eric Meng.
Ah, very rare that you see that happening, but still a 10-point lead para sa Ginebra. Here's Alapag, getting a high screen from Carey, playing peekaboo against Dimaunahan, taking up a three, and Asi Taulava with a strong rebound and a putback against Eric Meng.
Getting better positioning against Eric Meng, Asi Taulava just powering his way for that basket and a chance to complete a three-point play because Mark Caguioa tried to provide some help defense from the backside, could not get the ball, instead got Asi Taulava's head.
Aray, sa pool yung dilaw na buhok, pero may foul si Mark Caguioa, and the score is pegged at 64-56, still in favor of the Gin Kings. Oops. Bosses on hand, the Caranco brothers, Lasser Danding and his wife, and of course his brother Henry. And here's Asi Taulava missing a free throw, but
one more free throw for Asi Taulava. Lane violation on the part of Barangay Ginebra.
For sa paraw, ang hinihingi ni referee. Back, kapalikot siya. Referee Cruz. Puro siyang referee natin mga kaibigan. Referee Cruz, referee Kalongkagin, and referee Kulanag. And this is not a referee because this is Alex Dimaunahan going down the paint, missing the layup. And Gonzalez clears the board. Here's Alapag. They're trying to do something about the 7-point lead of the Gingis. Alapag inside. Talk about versus speed. But he can't get the layup to stay.
Another sorry miss for Jimmy Alapag, the small guy. Tiny Jimmy Alapag challenging everybody with that penetration.
This is Mark Caguioa. Crossover against Bonavena. Jumper from the baseline is blocked from behind by the veteran.
Not in front of me, says Bong Ravena.
Not with the long and quick arms of Bong Ravena. Alapag finding Gonzalez. Here's Carey inside quickly to Taulava, who attracts a double team. Out to Gonzalez. To Alapag, teeing up a three from the right wing. Lakas ng konti at meron ding malakas na tulak mula kay Banjo Calpito.
Somehow the call was kind of late. Everybody reacting to the call, especially this guy, Coach Alan Kaidik. Oh.
And we got a substitution on the floor as you see this replay of the miss of Alapag. And there's the... Ayan. The what me? I didn't push. Ayan. Okay, back to live action. Asi Taulava using his size.
Good strap. A good drop step move by Asi Taulava, even using his left hand to make that basket.
Well, Timex, folks, is our official timer of the PBA games. We'd like to remind you that. Please don't forget that. Here's Caguioa against Ravena, turning on the speed, driving hard, gets Harvey Carey out of the picture, and there's a foul here, hand check foul.
Mark Caguioa getting past his defender, Bong Ravena not keeping in step with Mark Caguioa, instead nudges him for the foul.
Well, the phone fouls have been chopping down this lead little by little. Lima na lang po ang kalamangan ng Ginebra with 4:39 to go here in the third quarter. Aris Dimaunahan driving against Alapag, off the glass, malakas, offensive rebound for Sunday Salvacion, fade away from the baseline. It won't drop. Harvey Carey with a big rebound out to Alapag quickly. Here come the phone fouls. Alapag thought about the three. Sabi niya, ikaw na lang, Paring Bong. At si Paring Bong, hindi naman niya pinahiya ang kumpiyansa ni Jimmy Alapag as he drained the triple. Don't look now, folks. We got a ball game, 64-62.
What a time for Bong Ravena to make that shot. He's been scoreless in 5 attempts, and for that time to make that three-pointer, that's big-time basketball for Bong Ravena.
Jun Limpot could not get the short jumper.
What a pass!
Carey, what a pass! Awesome pass with the jiggle and the jimmy from Jimmy Alapag, leading the charge for the phone passes. Don't look now. We've got a tied ball game. Here's a spark plug, no look pass by Alapag inside the Carey. Catch your breath, why don't you? I need to. We got a timeout, please stick around. For Jimmy Alapag, welcome back, folks. Jimmy Alapag is doing so much more damage off that timeout. He converted in a fancy layup. He now has 24 big points to lead the phone pals, and here they come again. They are in the lead, 66-64. Asi Taulava!
And it's all Jimmy Alapag. Jimmy Alapag creating everything.
Grabe.
For Coach Paul Wolfert and the Talk and Text phone files. It's a 10-0 blast. Now up by 4 points, 68-64. Jimmy Alapag just superb in this game.
Grabe. Superb indeed is Jimmy Alapag, as he right now has tied his career high of 20. Short breather from the action. At kung sa tingin nyo, sa hard court ang action with nice eye of the needle pass by Jimmy Alapag to the happy Harvey Carey. Nako,
sige coach, alam na alam ko ang kalibre ni Hector Calma. Maybe give Jimmy Alapag some more seasons here in the PBA. Baka lagpasan pa.
Lagpasan pa?
Oo. Ang pinakita ni Hec Calma.
Ito naman, sabi ni Eric Mick, babawihan ko ng tres. Ayaw pumasok. Medyo maaga na naman sa shot clock yun ng Ginebra as Coach Alan Kedic picks up Alex Rizano, probably to pull out Eric Mick. Here's Taulava, double teamed, looking for a friend, finds Patrick Fran, finds Alapag, kicking out again to Fran, 4-3, it's just out, but Martelan with the hustle, Martelan tapping it to himself.
Beating two players, Lago and Eric Mick in that last rebound play, Martelan. Creating a basket for himself, and Ginebra's last field goal was in the 6:14 mark of this quarter.
Ayan, nakabawi na sa'yo, narinig ka ni Eric Mick. So after 4 minutes and 12 seconds of silence for the Gin Kings, finally, Eric Mick breaks the silence as he chops down the Talk and Text lead to 4 points. Here's Alapag. He's not yet done. The guy has hardly rested. He rested siguro the last 44 seconds lang, no?
The last 14 seconds of the second
half.
Quarter.
Uh-huh.
Then the whole halftime break.
Meron pa ba yan?
And don't look now.
Aba, aba.
Aba, aba, everybody.
Up on their feet, ang Ginebra fans. Very interested to see the entry of the rookie, Rob Johnson, who, if I'm not mistaken,
his
will
first
be
game.
His first game.
Oh.
And he's quite happy to be tapped for the first time. And he's taking... Alam mo itong batang to, matapang to. Yan, nakita ko na yung tapang yan sa PBA.
Oh, I've seen him.
And I think he's going to take this opportunity as a big challenge to try and stop this man, Jimmy Alapag. He's got 24 big points. At ito na po, very interesting to see the challenge of the rookie, Rob Johnson, who, by his mere looks alone, is intriguing everybody with the way he is built like a rock, quick like a fox, and mighty, mighty brave like a lion. And we'll see what this guy can do, what this kid can do against another rookie, Jimmy Alapag. And here comes Rob Johnson to the cheers of the crowd.
This guy, Rob Johnson, can really execute. He's a good dribbler, a good penetrator. The only question would be if he is ready for this game.
Nice pass by Mark Aguiwa to Eric Mack. Difficult hook shot around.
Look at Alex Rizano.
Hard foul by Asi Taulava. And oh boy, they're loving the action, folks. The crowd at the big dome is loving it. Check this out. Difficult fade away.
Look at Alex Crisano battling for the rebound against two defenders. At that time, pumping Asi Taulava. And Asi Taulava grabbing Alex Crisano by the neck.
Aray, sakit nun. At humihingi ng traveling si Coach Paul Wolpert. Pero Coach, pagbigyan mo na siguro si Alex, nasaktan na nga eh.
Oo.
Ito,
and partner, with the absence of Rommel Adducul, definitely this guy, Alex Crisano, has shown Coach Alan Kadig, Coach, pwede ako.
Yes, pwede ako, Coach. 4 points in the ball game for Alex Rizano so far. And aside from the 4 points, the hustle, the rebounds, the defense.
The intangibles.
Bata mo, 8 rebounds. Oh, grabe.
3 of 3 free throw shooting. Make that 4 of 4.
And you didn't jinx him this time at least. Although Asi Taulava tried to pull a fast one, and I doubt you'd get away with that, Asi. And here comes the phone calls. At ako, nagpiling pahinga sa bakas si Jimmy Alapag.
Oh, pare, what a move by Coach Paul Wolfert. Ayaw niya isabay si Jimmy Alapag kay
Johnson?
Rob Johnson, di ba? Ewan mo.
May takot ba siya sa depensa ni Johnson? Malay natin. Pelano, 4-3, drains it!
So many three-pointers converted in this quarter alone.
Grabe.
By the Talk and Text phone calls. Make that 6 3 points in this quarter.
Here's Rob Johnson out to Elmer Lago. Wide open, all day to shoot a three, but it's going to be called a two by referee Kalungkagin.
That's a long two for Lago, and you don't leave Lago wide open. He could bury that shot.
Oh, here's Asi Taulava again attracting his barkada of white shirts.
Not a good shot selection.
Oh, that's not the kind of shots you want Asi Taulava to take if you are Coach Paul Wolpert. Caguioa quickly to Crisano. Nice pass to Eric Menk, who finishes saying thank you very much, buddy Alex.
Not only creating for himself Alex Crisano at that time, even issuing an assist to Eric Menk.
Ang gandang pass na ni Alex Crisano, showing the patience. It is Belano. Step back three, gets bumped, no foul is called, and that is an air ball. And look, Coach Wolford is not a happy man.
Up in his arms, asking for the foul.
Pero medyo mahinahon ngayon yung angal niya, no? Kasi alam niya may technical.
Meron lang isa eh. Pag meron pang isa, out ka na.
Oh, ingat ka lang, Coach Paul. That's what one technical can do to you early in the game. Eric Menk, looking for something to happen with his teammates, moving around. Hand off to Rob Johnson. Shot clock down to five. He's got to do something about this. Quick steps. Rob Johnson inside. Gets erased by Asi Taulava. Asi says, welcome to the PBA, Rob Johnson.
Rob Johnson just beating his defender, but not Asi Taulava. And look at this. Getting past Don Mel Belano. Going for the basket. Asi Taulava waiting for him. Blocking his shot. And look at the stare down.
Rob Johnson meet the Rock. And that's why they call him the Rock. Burado ka. Get that weak shot out of here. And Rob Johnson gets his initiation in the PBAS. We had a 30-second timeout, which we all need. And it's called by the phone pals. Salamat, Coach Paul, for this timeout.
What a rare opportunity for him to be playing.
Well, he saw the shot clock winding down to five. So I have to do something about it. But now the shot clock is down to 1 second.
And 2 seconds on the game clock. Oh, what a
nice
pass!
Nice pass to Eric!
Executed play! Ooh.
What a sneak pass there by Elmer Lago. And there's still 0.3 seconds left on the clock as they're all celebrating. And Asi will jack this one from 3/4 court. It's out of bounds. And what a ball game we have on our hands, folks. Big run by the phone pass to get back here. A big counter run by the Jin Kings to get back. Look at this pass.
Baseline out of bounds play. Somebody popping out, leaving Eric Menk wide open for that easy basket. And that's difficult to execute with only 1 second on your shot clock.
What a ball game we got on our hands, folks. An exciting fourth quarter right here for you as we come back. Somebody giving an oxygen tank. This is your PBA.
As he just hit that squeaky shot to finish the third quarter to tie this ball game up 74-all. And boy, folks, we've got a great ball game for you tonight. I don't want to say exciting because that is an understatement with the kind of action we are witnessing here at the Araneta Coliseum. And Coach Deo are scoring by quarter.
Ginebra getting a jump on Tocantex during the first quarter, 28-17. Tocantex getting back in the second quarter and the third quarter to tie the game at 74-all at the start of the fourth quarter.
Napakalaking explosion in the third quarter, 34 points by the phone pals, but Ginebra still had enough in them to get this game tied up at the end of three. Here's Asi Taulava. Patrick Frantisa pa three. Count that two. Ang dami ng three-point shots po mga kaibigan ng phone pals here in the second half. They've been living behind the arc.
And well, the double teaming of Barangay Ginebra, definitely one guy will be
opening
left open and nobody rotating well on
Rob
the
Johnson
shooter.
Getting away out to Elmer Lago in the corner. Short. And it just goes out of bounds in favor of the phone pals. Sayang, nalibre si Rob Johnson.
Correct.
Kinikot pa niya.
Well, it's a set play, no, for the shooters on the corner. Somebody trying to penetrate to the wide open Lago. Unfortunately, hindi lang pumasok.
This is Ravenna looking for the Rock, who has not done much damage, but giving good passes like that to Mark Delan, as he can't get the finger roll to stick in the hoop. Pero may foul.
Asi Taulava contended to issuing assist passes like that to Mark Delan. Mark Delan at that play was being guarded by the much smaller Rob Johnson. And no way Rob Johnson can challenge the shot. As we take a look at the black shots, Tocantex 6, Barangay Ginebra, isa pa lamang.
I'm a Coach Leo. Let's take this opportunity to talk about Asi Taulava. He has 13 points in the game. But as we said nga, not much of a major factor offensively in terms of scoring. So tingin mo ba itong fourth quarter, kailangan na niya medyo probably to force the situation a little more? Kasi nga, siya main man eh. Or they should be content with the outside shots he's creating.
The way he's been playing, no? The way he's been using his other weapons in his arsenal, issuing assists, creating situations for the other players. Tingin ko okay na,
okay
no?
Na. Okay,
okay
na, no?
Because points would come that easy, but issuing assists, getting your teammates involved is a lot harder.
Correct. So far, Asi Taulava doing an excellent job of getting his teammates involved. And Mark Aquino, he's number three. That's way off the glass and to the left.
And at that time, nobody got involved except Mark Caguioa.
Well, 5-point lead now to open up this fourth quarter. The Gin Kings have yet to score as the Phone Bells have done five of their own with 10:16 to go in our fourth. Patrick Fran looking again for their anchor, Asi Taulava. Kick out pass, cross court. Balik kay Patrick Fran. Isa pang tres, Patrick Fran, malakas. Rebounds. Scramble goes to
Bong Rabena
with a foul.
Foul at that time. Good ball movement on the part of Tokentex. Asi Taulava realizing there was a double team from his side to the cross court, and ball movement, extra passes ending up to Patrick Fran. Wide open, hindi lang pumasok.
Sayang lang, no? Pero maganda na yung patience at ball movement ng phone fouls. And Rob Johnson is still in the game, folks, for Barangay Ginebra. If you just joined us, he entered with the cheering of the crowd as this is his first appearance in the PBA. We got a foul on the play. And if you're just joining us, folks, good evening. Thank you for tuning in to us at NBN4. This is your PBA coverage brought to you by NBN Sports. My name is TJ Manotok, together with Coach Leo Isaac and Patricia Bermudez on the sidelines. As you see, Coach Leo, our three-point field goals, ba?
Umuulan ng 3 points para sa Tokentex.
Grabe.
10 of 26 as compared to only 4 of 14 para sa Barangay Ginebra.
Rob Johnson directing traffic for the Gin Kings. Lago for Eric Menk. A little soft in the pass. Menk goes strong to the basket against Mark Delan and just runs over him, but picks him up.
Former buddies.
Friend pa rin kita.
Pero they play hard basketball.
Yun talaga.
They respect each other.
Two excellent warriors on the court, but friends off the court. And that's a third personal foul para kay Mark Delan.
Also, the third team foul for Tokentex.
Hindi maganda yun.
Hindi maganda. With still 9.5 left into the final period.
Rob Johnson looking for a friend. Finds Eric Menk from 15. Driving against Mark Delan. Off the glass. Patay ang butike. At ito si Patrick Fran.
Going hard to the basket. Eric Menk just losing his balance at that time.
Delano for the three. But there's a foul away from the ball as referee Cruz quickly calls this foul.
Alex Pisano not giving Asi Taulava any advantage in the shaded area at that time. Not giving up any space for Asi Taulava. Instead, he was called for a foul.
Grabe yung grian nila. Denying Asi the position he wants in the paint.
And look at the way they bang bodies.
Oh, here's Asi Taulava again. Hard body against hard body. Fran swinging it out. It's now with Ravenna. Getting a screen from Telan. Step back three. For Ravenna, can't get that to drop. Mark Caguioa up high for the rebound. Here comes Rob Johnson, and the crowd likes him already without doing much so far. They just like the way he looks. Lago. Johnson takes a three, and he drains it.
That's a long two.
Correct me, Rob Johnson with a long two. His first field goal in the PBA with a nice smile.
And that excites the Ginebra crowd here at the Araneta Center. Maybe that could spark the whole Ginebra team.
Oh, that could do something for them. Rob Johnson now 1-for-2 from the field as he was blocked earlier by Taulava. Patrick Fran, another three from the left wing. Boy, they have taken so many threes, Coach Leo. Ang dami nilang attempts. Siguro na sa 28-29 attempt nila.
The defensive ploy of Barangay Ginebra is only allowing them a lot of outside shots, and they've been taking it from three.
Si Crisano gusto sumali sa three-point shooting party. Not, kahit sabi ni Alan kay Dick, what?
Not his range.
Not at all. Balik ang bola sa phone fouls as they enjoy a three-point lead. Not very comfortable at the rate this game has been played. Taulava spinning baseline, going hard against Eric Menk. No call whatsoever. Clean block now for Eric Menk. Here's Caguioa stepping on the brakes. Brian Crisano inside against Ravenna. Easy pickings for the big boy, Alex Crisano, who now has 8 points in the ballgame.
Barangay Ginebra having the numbers in that transition play. The trailer, Alex Crisano, getting a good cross from Mark Caguioa, just laying it in for 2 points.
Mark Delan for a long two. They've taken so many long shots, and now they're starting to go cold, Coach Leo.
Oh, they should take a lot of penetrations, move the ball well, let the defense gang up on you and hit the open man.
Here's Mark Caguioa challenging the defense of Conte Vilano. A little too much challenge there as that push-off was too strong, and Delano sprawled to the floor at offensive foul. Ang tatawagin kay Mark Caguioa as he gets his fourth personal foul. And we got a timeout on our hands, folks, by the Phone Pals. Our score is 1-point lead for the Phone Pals with 7:21 to go in the ballgame. As Alapag is now back in the lineup para sa Phone Pals. At ngayon ang challenge kay Robson. So, here's the double screen. Uh-oh, he goes around it. Wide open is Alapag. Coach, kanina bang problema ng Ginebra yun? How
lucky
can they stop
break,
that?
Lucky break for Rob Johnson. The shot of Jimmy Alapag. Was it good?
Johnson for the pull-up.
Return play. Rob Johnson quickly answers with a miss.
Oh, and Alan Kedic signaling to him from the sidelines. Rob, kailangan muna ng four passes. Asi Taulava gets smothered from behind by Alex Crisano, but there was a lot of body smothering him too. As Alex Crisano picks up his fourth foul.
Good timing on the part of Alex Crisano. That time he realized that only Sunday Salvation was defending Asi Taulava. This time, it's my turn to give you a hard foul.
Oh, it's my turn to block your light of day. And Asi Taulava back to the line as I will stop singing for the benefit of our basketball-loving fans.
Asi Taulava, only a 50% free throw shooter. He misses his first free throw.
Well, in our fourth quarter, the only guy who has scored, the only guys who have scored for the Phone Pals have been Patrick Fran and Mark Talan. Only one field goal, which has been a three-point shot.
Extended minutes for this guy, Rob Johnson.
Bah, he's seen about, what, 8 minutes already of playing time. As we'd like to remind you, the Timex is our official timer of the PBA games. Here's Sunday Salvation having a quiet ball game so far, not much damage. Here's Jun Limpot, isa pa itong medyo matahitahimik ng konti. Working against Asi Taulava, forcing the shot off the glass, too strong. Kailan with the rebound.
Oh. He had to with only 2 seconds left on the shot clock.
Alapag quickly inside to Asi Taulava, who had good position but was blocked from behind by Elmer Lago. Here's Rob Johnson out to Lago, going for a long two, and he drains that to the delight of the crowd. And don't look now, but the Gin Kings have once again tied the game, and the fans are loving it.
Good transition offense on the part of Barangay Ginebra. Rob Johnson hitting the wide open Lago for a twinner.
Asi Taulava baseline against five white shirts. He likes that shot, plus the foul. And that's the kind of celebration we usually see from the Rock.
The health defense was kind of late at that time. As we take a look at this lob pass coming from Mark Talan. No health defense on the blind side.
Wala na, no?
See, Asi Taulava having his way.
Kanina kasi sanay si Crisano na paglingon niya na si Eric Menk.
At the time, but then by the time Asi Taulava makes his turn, right away, nandun na yung health defense. At that time, Elmer Lago not in the proper position to provide help for Alex Crisano.
Now, Coach, Asi now has 16 points. And how do you like that strategy of Ginebra of forcing him to the baseline?
Well, it's a ploy by Coach Alan Kaysik for Asi Taulava to go to the baseline and limit his movement
tapos
to that
trap
spot.
Agad,
and then the blindside help would be there, trapping Asi Taulava, try to get the ball from him or make him commit some errors.
But so far, it's been doing all right. Nothing spectacular. Here's Rob Johnson. He can be spectacular at times when we've seen him in the PBL. A foul on the play on Asi Taulava.
A costly foul for Asi Taulava. That's his fifth personal foul.
Oh no, not good news for the Phone Pals. And we turn you over now to courtside with Patricia with our latest update. What's up there, Patricia?
Hey guys, expect the Phone Pals to run the ball even more and bank on the fact that Ginebra cannot double Asi Taulava that fast, so Asi can easily muscle his way to the basket, which is what he's been doing so far. To the whole team, he reminds them to play wiser defense. This is Coach Wolpert's game plan so far. But on the Ginebra Kings side, now that they're facing another tough and cohesive team, they got to improve on their decision making and their play in the end game. Back to you, TJ and Coach Leo.
Thank you so much, Patricia. As back to live action, nagmintis kanina si Elmer Lago, and here's Alapag once again turning on the turbo boosters.
The slight hesitation, then all of a sudden, boom, gets past his defender.
Diba nung ikaw naglalaro, bumabantay ka rin ng mga point guard paminsan-minsan, no? Kung natapat sa'yo ang isang Jimmy Alapag?
Kanina pa nagpapahinga yan.
yan ang kumpiyansa.
Kanina pa nagpapahinga yan.
Kanina pa kayo, naman.
Oh.
May duda pa kayo. Kanina defensive pa specialist.
Kanina pa nagpapahinga yan.
Hindi ko na lang tatanungin kung paano.
Oh.
Basta magpapahinga yan.
Dahil tapos na ang game, nagpapahinga na siya.
Ayun. Tapos na yun. Well, it's been a long time since we've seen somebody as quick and as explosive as Jimmy Alapag, as he's now on the stripe. Booking his 26th point. This is career high time para kay Jimmy Alapag, as his previous career high was 24 points. And back in the ballgame is Harvey Carey and Norman Gonzalez, as Asi Taulava will take a short breather. I'm sure he'll be back.
Good timing on the part of Coach Paul Wolpert, with still 5 minutes and a half remaining dito sa ating fourth and final period. Pahinga muna si Asi. Siguro mga 4 minutes, cambio uli yan.
And Jimmy Alapag books his second free throw as the lead of the Phone Pals back up now to 4 points, 84-89. Sorry, 5:19 to go in our fourth and final quarter.
Ginebra has to score in this possession.
Ito yung crucial stretch of the fourth quarter.
Correct.
No?
Especially, 5 to 3 minutes. Especially if your opponent's up by 4 points, wow, you have to make a basket.
Either you catch up or you stick close.
Correct.
Kasi kung papabayaan mo yung maging 8-10 na ko.
Down to the last 2 minutes, mahirap medyo na mahirap na yan.
Mahirap na yun. You're better off keeping this game close and keeping in striking distance. As Rob Johnson finally steps out and balik sa ball game si Bal David, here's Mark Caguioa to Jun Limpot against Harvey Carey. Inside, hook shot, short, good defense there by Harvey Carey as he gets the loose ball.
Harvey Carey holding his own against the much experienced Jun Limpot. At that time, a soft sky hook by Jun Limpot. Medyo kapos ng konti.
Mong Ravena looking inside for Harvey Carey, gets a screen instead. Step back, driving, kicking, Patrick Francis on the shot clock. They swing it to Alapag, driving hard to baseline. Here comes Alapag! I'm lost for words. What a move!
Getting past the defender, going to the baseline, floating in midair, challenging everybody, making the basket. Jimmy Alapag.
Anong height mo?
Anong height
mo? Yan ang sinasabi niya. Anong height mo? Ako 5'8 lang. Ayun, 6'4, 6'5. Diyos ko dai, Jimmy Alapag. Mark Caguioa draining a step back three.
A timely jumper for Mark Caguioa, cutting down the lead to 3 points.
Grabe yung galaw ni Alapag.
Oh,
I still
partner.
Can't get over it. What a move. Here's Patrick Fran. Out to Ravena, out to Alapag. Let's see if he's going to do something again. Inside to Carey, strong against Eric Menk, and he drains the top shot with a foul.
The rookie, Harvey Carey, showing his stuff against Eric Menk, going to the baseline, challenging the defense of Eric Menk, making the shot, was even fouled. Now has chance to complete a three-point play.
Well, the phone foul still showing. Interesting to think, what if Jimmy Alapag did not get injured last year and made the national team? I think he would have helped. What
definitely
do you think,
the way he's been performing, as we take a look at the field goal conversion for Tocantex, a big increase from 33% to 47% in the second half, while Barangay Ginebra down from 42% to 38%.
Well, that time around, Jun Limpot carving space for himself inside as he got the twinner to go. 4 points na lang po ang kalamangan ng phone pals. Here's Bong Ravena. Inside traffic. Patrick Van with the loose ball. Dipsy do. Learning a thing or two from Jimmy Alapag. Sabi niya, paling Jimmy, kaya ko rin yan. Ito, ito. Yan.
Patrick Fran, sabi nga natin, medyo alahoy ng konti. Oh. Pero 2 points is 2 points.
Parang horse lang yan eh.
Oo. Oh.
Sabi ni Jimmy.
Gayahin mo ito mamaya, oh. Patrick.
Sabi niya, Patrick, can you do this? Sabi ni Patrick, yes, I can. And we got a foul on the play. It's going to go against RB Carey with his fourth. And check out this Patrick Fran Dipsy Doo version of the Jimmy Alapag move. Yeah. As we said, 2 points is 2 points, and it still gets an applause from Coach Paul Wolpert as they are up by 6 points.
What is important for Barangay Ginebra is just to keep in pace, no? Mahaba pa to. It's still 3 minutes and 30 seconds left dito sa ating final period. Eric Menk on the free throws. Made his first free throw. Now has a chance to cut the lead back to 4 points if he makes, no? Yung sinasabi natin, huwag ka lang kakalas ng konti dahil pagdating ng last 2 minutes, ibang story na yan, lalo na kung nakadikit ka.
Eric Menk now booking his 28th point of the ball game. Eric Menk really playing an excellent game tonight so far, but his Gin Kings are down by 4. Bong Ravena to Norman Gonzalez. No Asi Taulava right now for the phone fouls as he has 5 fouls. Inside to Bong Ravena. Backing down Elmer Lago. Alapag 4-3. Oh, just in and out. And Norman Gonzalez once again at the right place at the right time and saving it even. And he saved it to the right man. That was Harvey Carey as they pick up another foul. Looks like it's on Mark Caguioa as he gets his
first, the sorry miss by Jimmy Alapag. A three-pointer, the ball was already in, decided to pop out, and then the extra effort from Norman Gonzalez, issuing a pass to Harvey Carey, who was fouled.
Ito na naman, coach, yung small lineup ng Talking Text, pero nakaka-offensive rebound pa rin sila.
Oo.
Laking bagay.
Sabi nga sa'yo, it's not the height that matters when you want to get those rebounds, it's the heart.
Yep.
Remember Dennis Rodman?
6'7 lang yun.
Oo. Hindi ngayon. Ay, naku naman. 29.
Grabe. At ang average niya, 16 lang. 16,
boundary.
Malapit ang doblehin ang kanyang average. At I wouldn't be surprised if he does just that. 6-point lead for the Phone Pals with 2:40 to go. David to Caguioa, out to Lago, inside to Eric Mech. Fade away against Harvey Carey. Booked up. Hunter.
Difficult shot, partner.
Ang hirap nun.
Oh, the degree of difficulty for Eric Menk to make that basket and for him to take that kind of a shot in a crucial stage of the game.
They needed that shot. Big time shot there by Eric Menk. Down to 4 points ang alamangan ng Phone Pals. Front, inside to Carey. Will he get the double team like Asi? I don't think so, but a tough shot.
Single coverage.
Here's Bal David against three.
No make numbers.
Caguioa open in the middle. Floater by Mark Caguioa. That is his trademark shot. And folks, we are entering the most exciting last 2 minutes. Brought to you by Hope, the luxury cigarettes. Wow, what a ball game. And it's going to be a full timeout by the Phone Pals, as long as you do also. Hang on to your seats. Mark Caguioa still doing the damage for the Gin Kings as they are only down by two.
On the field for 45% field goal conversion.
And here again is Jimmy Alapag out to Patrick Fran. Inside to Asi Taulava, was back and gets a double team quickly to Ravenna. Alapag, Patrick Fran, tees up on three. No.
Good ball movement on the part of Talk and Text. Wide open shot for Patrick Fran. Hindi lang pumasok.
That's exactly what they wanted. They did it to perfection. Everything but the shot. Here's Elmer Lago looking inside. Can't find a passing lane. David out to Caguioa. Jackson three in front of Patrick Fran. Short, but with the hustle there is Jun Limpot. Bagong shot lock para sa Gin Kings with 1:23 to go.
Nothing to hurry. They have to reset. They have to organize.
Deep inside. Limpot against the big man of the Phone Pals, and he gets bailed out by a foul.
Again, some action and the late call by the referee, this time drawing some reactions from the Talk and Text bench.
And he gets the fifth foul also of Harvey Carey.
Take a look at this. Jun Limpot one-on-one against Harvey Carey. There's the power move. There's the contact.
And may body
definitely, there's some contact.
Ayon, sa pool. He got some ball, but he also got some body. And Jun Limpot goes to the line for very important free throws as he will attempt to tie this ball game. Jun Limpot is averaging 89% and I just jinxed him.
What a time for Jun Limpot to miss.
Pero
a free throw.
Yung, nabanggit ko yung percentage nung na-release na.
Yun na nga, partner.
Not really my fault.
Correct. And considering this is already the fourth period, kanina pa naglalaro yung pagod na ang pulso ni Jun Limpot.
Second shot, he misses again. Oh, but don't look now. Elmer Lago with a big offensive rebound as Harvey Carey could not handle it.
What hassle by Lago.
Eric Mech against Carey, who's got five fouls. Spinning, gets the fake,
move.
And he gets the sixth and final foul of Harvey Carey.
Good
Malaking
move.
Bagay yon.
Oh.
And Eric Mech will go to the line. A new fishing expedition, Eric Mech. Paid off, mga kaibigan.
Correct. Good move by Eric Menk. At that time, he got one over Harvey Carey, who didn't realize that he would still be able to make that pump pick. Here's the spin move. There's the pick.
Rookie.
Don't leave the floor. As some coaches would say, never bite into a fake.
Rookie, huli ka doon. Ako, and the rookie has just fouled out of the ball game. Itong si Harvey Carey finishing the ball game with 14 points and 11 rebounds.
Oh-ho.
And Eric Menk also feeling the pressure with a minute and 4 seconds to go.
Three consecutive misses on the part of Barangay Ginebra on the free throw line.
Sakit yon. By this time, they should be up by one with the free throws they have just missed in the last moments of this game.
Coach Alan Kaedig.
That was his first miss of the night, by the way. And free throw number two goes in. 1 point lead for the Phone Pals, and Alapag brings up the leather.
Exactly 1 minute left in the game.
Here's that double high screen play again. Bal David fighting over it. Alapag can't get a shot off.
That time they played it well.
Taulava is double teamed. Kicks out to Alapag.
7 seconds.
Shot clock winding down. Alapag goes inside. Kick into Mike Talan. Gets blocked from behind. And the ball will go to Alex Cresano.
And no
Here
goal.
Come the Kings. No timeout being called.
Not even a foul being called in the last play.
They opt not to call a timeout, even though they do have full timeouts to call. Shot clock winding down to 9. David to Eric Menk against Mike Talan. Pull up jumper. Voila! And the rebound goes to Jimmy Alapag. And he is fouled by Eric Menk.
That's a good play by Eric Menk. They have to foul Jimmy Alapag. They can't let Jimmy Alapag waste those precious seconds. Even if Jimmy Alapag makes these free throws, definitely ball will swing back to Barangay Ginebra and they'll have a chance to either tie the count or even win the game for them.
Coach, assess this last play. Ginebra had timeouts to call.
Correct.
But they opted not to. Maybe because ayaw nilang ma-set up yung depensa.
Correct. Good.
Phone fouls. But I guess they went to the guy that they had to go to with 30 points. Don't say Eric Menk.
Eric Menk missing an open jumper. Just measuring as we take a look. Coach Alan kay Dick. Hinayang na hinayang. Oh. Hindi pumasok yung side jumper.
Pero ang sayang doon, penalty itong phone fouls.
Oo.
Hindi niya pinasok.
But what is more important than TJ? Even if Jimmy Alapag converts both free throws, Coach Alan Kaidik has the luxury
yes.
of calling a timeout, setting a play
and
with
sure
still 17 seconds left. Maski 3 to. Points pa yan, pwede pa tayo mag-set up ng 3-point play.
He might even still go for a quick 2. Kasi meron pa naman silang timeouts. Oy, but missed by Alapag. Here's the jump ball of the rebound. And it's with Asi Taulava.
They have to foul. They have to foul.
And Meg fouls Alapag, who tries to pretend like he is shooting a three-point shot. Sorry, Jimmy. I don't think you'll make the Oscars this tonight. Pero malaking bagay yung rebound dun, or actually the loose ball pickup by Asi Taulava.
Nobody wanted that way. They were expecting Jimmy Alapag to convert the last free throw. All of a sudden, he misses a shot. Asi Taulava providing the hustle, getting down the rebound.
At mantakin mo ha, kung saan ang galing si Asi.
Oh, oh.
Nakuha niya sa half court pero ang galing siya dun sa poste.
Oh, what hassle. Look at the numbers.
Again, Alapag was played a lot of minutes tonight. Coach, sa tingin mo fatigue ba yan?
Correct. Oh, definitely, it's not the same shooting hand you had during the first quarter. It's the fourth quarter. You've been in there for about 44 minutes. Yeah, boy, the touch has been there.
30
now,
points, 11 assists. Big second free throw, he drains it, and they're gonna call a full timeout here for sure. As Coach Alan Kaidik, lima para sa Ginebra, Caguioa, Lago, Menk, Limpot, at Bal David. All of them can shoot the three. Here comes the inbound. David is open. Fakes. Menk is open for three. And what a shot!
Oh,
by Eric Menk. My goodness, what a ball game!
I told you they'll go for the three. I know Coach Alan Kaidig.
Woo! What a ball game! Pero teka lang!
Teka muna, meron pa tayong oras!
Pero teka lang! Teka muna mga kaibigan, tabla po tayo pero meron pang 5.1 seconds. What a big shot by Major Payne! 34 points for Eric Menk. Nice fake by Bob David. Kicking it to a wide open Eric Menk, who had all day to shoot, and he hit nothing but the bottom of the net.
Talk about confidence, Eric Menk just hitting one from the quarter court.
Huge shot by Major Payne. I tell you what, this is a really big thing because a lot of people have been speculating the early play of Eric Menk in the first couple of games, even though they were winning. Hindi ganun kalakas ang kanyang production. But in the last game, he had 24 points. Tonight, he has 34 points. And boy, this is the Eric Menk that we know.
Eric Menk, Major Payne, just showing he could hit it during crunch time.
And has denied Alapag.
They denied Alapag.
From the parking lot. Wala. Taking over the rebound. There's still time. No.
Not the shot they wanted. Good play by Coach Alan Kaidik.
Sayang may timeout si Marky.
Hindi
niya tinawag. He had the rebound with 1.3. But then again, what a game we're seeing, folks. Talk Index phone bounce refusing to die. Same with the Gin Kings as They are known for the never say die attitude. The Gin Kings are on a three-game losing skid while the Phone Pals are on a two-game winning skid. Here's Alapag leaving the dust behind with Rob Johnson.
Rob Johnson anticipating a pick and roll, but instead Jimmy Alapag going point baseline, leaving Rob Johnson eating his dust.
Ang sinabi ni Alapag, Rob Johnson, I see you there on my rearview mirror behind me. Naiwan na naman kita. And here's Alice Crisano out to Jun Limpot. Johnson, the lag, looking for Crisano, tapped from behind by Tilan. Four on the shot clock. Caguioa's got to do something about this. Lago 4-3, beating the shot clock, but can't get it to fall. And it's back with the phone fouls. Here's Asi, out to Alapag. Ravenna, Patrick Front fakes a three. Ravenna thought about it. Alapag, first three, nope. Inside, nako.
Nobody wanting to take the shot. Instead, a three-second violation will be called against the Phone Pals. Yung sinasabi natin, overpass.
Overpassing, sayang. They did have the shot a couple of times already. But back in the ballgame, mga kaibigan, it's Bal David at pinagpahinga si Rob Johnson, who came in at the very last play to really shadow Jimmy Alapag, and he did exactly that. Jun Limpot can't find an opening against Asi. Asi has five fouls though. Bal David forces a jumper and he rattles it home.
And with that shot of Bal David, Ginebra takes the upper hand, 98-97.
3-point shot pala yung mga kaibigan. Patrick Franz, sabi niya, bababoy ako! Hindi. Crisano with the rebound. Alapag with the hustle. And Asi with the putback.
Good play by Jimmy Alapag.
Jimmy Alapag is just everywhere.
Just stealing the ball away from
grabe
Alex Crisano, who grabbed that rebound.
Woo!
Masakit yun, pare.
Sakit yun, no?
No.
Na-rebound na eh. But anyway, it's only a 1-point lead for the Phone Pals as a careless pass by Jun Limpot, almost stolen by the quick hands of Bong Ravenna. And back in the game is the hero of the Gin Kings so far, Eric Menk, who's got 34 huge points together with
many rebounds.
His rebounds, aba, 16 lang naman. A miss there that time for the Gin Kings, and Taulava grabs the board. Sabi niya, let's take a while and slow this down. Alapag gets a high screen, kicking it out to Bong Ravenna. Out to Tilan, jacking up another three, and he drains it.
He wants a shot.
And he's loving it. Mark
Tilan.
That's a big shot, folks. Remember that shot, because that puts up the Phone Pals by 4 points. With 2:33 to go. Lago inside to Mick against Mark Tilan. Pull-up jumper, and he's not yet done. Eric Menk, 36 points.
Good thing he made that shot, but because nobody on the part of Barangay Ginebra was making any movement, if he missed that shot, definitely rebound will go to the Talking Text.
Ravenna open for three. Wala Taulava hard working inside for the offensive rebound. Nothing Eric Menk could do there because may pwesto na si Asi Taulava. But Asi Taulava has 5 fouls at hindi pa masyado pinupuntahan itong matchup na yun para baka makuha yung 6th foul niya. Folks, welcome to the last 2 minutes. Last number talaga to. I can't promise you that, as Elmer Lago promises you 3-point shots that last 2 minutes. Hope to you, brought to you by Hope. At may Hope pang Ginebra.
I told you a while ago, this guy doesn't hesitate to take those outside shots, and he just showed us he can bury one.
Outside shot by Alapag.
That's a long two.
He still has the shooter's bounce.
Partner, no? The soft bounce.
Grabe, no?
Ang dami ng tira nito si Jimmy Alapag. Puro soft bounce.
This is Menk again. Limpot, go back to Menk. Thank you very much to Limpot. Eric Menk with the easy two.
Jun Limpot just creating a situation for Eric Menk.
Coach, pansin mo si Asi, medyo pinaikot na lang si Limpot eh. So they might want to go back to that. Taulava again. Easy bucket, no defense whatsoever.
Correct, TJ. Good observation, TJ. The defense of Barangay Ginebra in that last play was nowhere to be found as Asi Taulava just converted an easy basket.
Well, there is fatigue involved, but it's physical fatigue and mental fatigue, folks. Here's Eric Menk going hard against Mark Tilan. Gets hacked by Mark, as Mark said, So young,
bola. But definitely, Eric Menk initiating contact, getting the better out of that spin move. Was fouled by Mark Tilan. Now has a chance to again bring back Ginebra closer to the Talk and Text phone pals.
Well, Eric Menk will go back to the foul line. And they are down by 3 points with exactly 1 minute to go. And I said earlier, last 2 minutes. Now I became a liar. And then I said last 2 minutes again. I hope I'm not a liar still. And we'd like to turn you over to Patricia at courtside. What's up there, Patricia?
Hey, TJ. Going to the overtime, Coach Alan K. Dick seemed quite frustrated because he knew he could have called another play if they just figured they gave him that time out. But you know what? He shrugged it off and gave the game plan to the Barangay Ginebra Kings and looked determined, intense, but at the same time, a little bit out of breath. The Ginebra team is tired, but what keeps them going is that never say die attitude that we also love. Back to you, Coach Leo and TJ.
Never say die indeed. Thank you so much, Patricia. And here come the offensive attack of the phone pass.
That time they switch.
Oh, nice
pick and roll.
Nice pass inside to Asi Taulava, losing the level, and Eric Menk picks it up.
Good hands.
Bal David.
Good hands by Mark Caguioa.
David quickly inside to Limpot against the land, forcing the issue. It will drop, tipped by Caguioa, and it's in the hands of Asi Taulava. 28 seconds to go, shot clock differential of about 7 seconds, Coach.
Jun Limpot forcing his way at that time, not finding the open man, instead challenging the defense, missed the shot.
7 second differential, shot clock, game clock. Do they opt to foul? I don't think this was intentional, but there is a foul called here. And this is only the first team foul of Ginebra here in the overtime. So hindi pa to free throw. And they can't find the passer, and now they get
the flag. Fouled.
They have the foul.
Just the foul.
They had the foul right there. Meron pa, isa pa, no? Ang penalty ba is two fouls or
two fouls?
No, sayang, actually, tapik niya bola, yung foul niya, yung hoop sa t-shirt, eh.
They want to challenge the free throw shooting of Tom.
And, once again, wala siyang mapasahan dahil ang bilis ng tapat.
Good coverage.
Correct. Pero walang pressure sa inbounder dito as Alapag finally gets the ball and
there's
Johnson
fouls. Right away, Rob Johnson a bit late, medyo na late pa lang konti because Jimmy Alapag out-sprinted him to the ball.
This time around, yung play ni Coach Paul Wolpert ay
correct.
Here's his first free throw. Pasok.
Still has the touch.
Eric Menk ngayon babalik sa laro kasama si Mark Caguioa. Pinanita nila si Rob Johnson at si Aris Dimon. And free throw is good likewise. And immediately, not a mess makapag-active shooting kaagad. Look at the three-point shooting numbers on your screens. Here we go. Eric Menk with the ball.
They have a foul to give.
He's open again. Eric Menk again. Eric Menk has done it again. Oh my goodness. Major pain. Talk about inflicting pain to the hearts of the phone pals. Pero teka lang! Hindi pa tayo tapos!
I just wondered why Talk and Text did not foul. They have a foul to give.
May foul to give, di ba, Coach? Tama ka dun. Check this out again. They could have fouled already right there. And Asi didn't know what to do, whether to switch or not. Wide open, Eric Menk. Nothing but the bottom of the net again.
And on the part of Mark Talan leaving Eric Menk, who has the ball, question who is the most dangerous man on the court, the man with the ball or the others who doesn't have the ball.
And that is the happiest man in the Araneta Coliseum. We'll be right back. Happiest man after that shot of major pain, who just has booked his 43rd point of the game. Here's Jimmy Alapag. High screen. He's open. Out to Bonaventure. Just my goal!
They nullified it.
It's waved off.
They nullified it. We go into the second overtime.
And Paul Wolpert was already going to the dugout, so confident that it was going to count.
Greg, I want to see the replay.
We'll check it out, folks. The best angle for my replays. My goodness. Here we go, Alapag. Gets the screen.
Driving throw. Hitting Bong Rabena for the open side jumper. Hitting.
Butike.
The butike.
Butike ko ba? Wanti naman. Alapag. Hail Mary. Asi gets the ball. Oh no, this just might count.
That counted.
Well,
make your decision.
Well,
make your decision.
Well, mga kaibigan. Well, mga kaibigan, our referee, meron tayong replay rule pag end game. Tayo po, wala tayong replay pag end game. And the decision is final. Ang tinawag ni lead referee Cruz ay knockout.
Doesn't count.
He number two. Alapag wins the tip. Will this be the last 5 minutes? I sure hope so. Alapag for three. Wala. Patrick Pantic offensive rebound. And here's Jimmy Alapag setting up the play with a fresh shot clock. Looking for this double high screen once again. Step back. In the paint. Jimmy Alapag is not yet done. Jimmy Alapag. 35 points and with 37 big points. I'm amazed.
Make that 38.
Mighty might. Jimmy Alapag. Maybe that'll stick, maybe not. But for tonight, I'll try using that. He's got the might, he's got the speed, and boy, he's mighty. Lago looking for Limpot, soft pass. 9 seconds to shoot. Caguioa has been quiet. Kicks out to Dimana, 3 seconds to shoot. Gotta do something, Aris against Taulava, and the offensive foul on the former teammate.
Extending his left hand toward of Asi Taulava. Asi Taulava, the
phone pass. Alapag popping out. This time he's got Dimona on it. Inside to Taulava against Crisano. Cross court. Ravenna fakes it inside, out the front, out to Alapag. 4-3. Strong rebound is tapped out of bounds by Mark Caguioa.
Once you enter a new overtime period,
Taulava double team. Inside, risky pass, stolen by Dimaunahan. This is Bal David. Quickly to Eric Menk, nako natapik, na puwan ni Elmer Lag. David, Dimaunahan. Back to David, no movement for the phone, for the Gin Kings. Menk, made to shoot, spinning baseline, difficult shot, rebound, Limpot. Thinking, going hard, wala pa rin. Rebound, si Limpot, but Limpot says, aki na to!
They have a new shot clock.
Limpot did a big recovery there. Menk back and down Tilan, who's got 5 fouls. And the deuce by Major Payne.
Just powering his way against Mark Clemens Tilan. Major Payne, meron pa.
Meron pa talaga after 45 big points. Alapag to Tilan. Fran from the left corner. Voila! And nobody wants to get the rebound. Here's Limpot finally.
Good boxing out by Eric Menk. Aris Dimonan.
Walang nauna sa kanya doon.
Oh, wala talaga
nauna. Nahiya.
Oh, good decision on the part of Paris. Not forcing the issue.
Inside to Limpot. Against Tilan, who's got 5. Is hemmed in and will be bailed out.
By a foul.
5 points now. He has broken that easily with 45. My goodness. And we still have 220 to go. He gets the Twitter to drop. Nice scoop shot by the main man.
The last time it was Eric Menk against Mark Tilan. This time it was Jun Limpot against Mark Tilan.
And don't look now, the Gin Kings are back in the lead. Tilan wants to do something about that. Off the glass, wala. Taulava with the rebound, put back. And I'll try and say this again. This is the last 2 minutes brought to you by Hope, the luxury cigarette.
Hindi na ako naniniwala sa'yo. Kanina mo pa sinasabi yan eh.
Okay, fine. I just have to say it anyways. It's the last. Here's Menk, Limpot again against the 5 fouls of Tilan. Back him down, losing his footing. And a big steal by Donde Pilalo. Here come the phone fouls. Alapag out the front. We have time.
No
up
numbers,
by one.
No numbers. That's a good decision. Set your offense.
This is an eternity of basketball. 1:23 to go. Pilalo wide open for three. Malakas. Easy rebound. Para kay Bal David. And they want to call a timeout.
Just a one boards to assist.
Here's Bal David spinning against Alapag off the glass and it gets the drop.
The flash. Bal David showing everybody. Meron pa rin.
And Bal David likes to hit big shots against the four fouls.
Definitely.
Alapag quickly to Milano.
Talagang pagkakalaban mo itong team na to. Super ganado ka. Hindi pa rin tapos.
in this game. As he hits the second one, 1 point lead, exactly 1 minute to go.
Bringing back the lead to Talk and Text.
I don't know if this is going to be the last 1 minute, but hey, I tried. Dimaunahan, hand off to Lago for quickly for a three. Big offensive board by Aris. Out of the bit, new shot luck, but there's a foul. Sana may manalo na. But it's exciting as it. David. To Limpot. What about it? Kicking out. Eric Menk for three. Why not? He's been hot. Oh, just moved up. Lago with a big putback. Lago with a huge putback. They're now up by one.
Eric Menk almost making a three-pointer. The ball deciding to pop out, but camps Elmer Lago for the putback.
Alapag finds his way inside. Oh, just moved out. And a big rebound by Eric Menk.
They have to foul. They have to foul.
Both fouls need to foul. Oh. And I think they fouled the perfect.
Again, we go back to what we said earlier. Even him, if he makes this free throw, Talk and Text will call a timeout.
Rattles home for Aris Dimaunahan. Fasten your seatbelts. 12.8 to go. Here we go. Taulava to front. Quickly for three. Wala. No score. Jun Limpot gets fouled. Things in this your league, the PBA. First free throw is good.
Jun Limpot has a chance to even up the lead if he makes this free throw.
And he does. No timeouts para sa phone fouls. Alapag fishing the foul. Walang foul doon si Dimaunahan. And that is the ball game. 122-117. The Gin Kings survive double overtime to break their three-game losing skid. And Alan Kaidik breathes a big sigh of relief as we will hang on the air. And Coach Leo, we have to pick one guy for our
best. Iba. Sino pa ba? Sino nagpa-overtime? Si Eric Menk para sa ating best player of the game.
At yan ang ngiti ng isang best player na nagpapanalo.
Kita mo naman ang mga numbers niya. 45 points, 17 rebounds on 17 of 31 field goal conversion. Ang taas.
Grabe nga naman. Boy, what an exciting ball game. And folks, I promise you, the excitement will not hold Patricio Bermudez. Thank you, Coach Leo Isaac. Nice working with you.
Thank you very much, TJ.
Excellent ball game. This has been TJ Manotok saying thanks so much and stick around.